Hello, this is your Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan program. We hope that you will find our presentation precise, joke-heavy, and just right. Thanks.
To the Friday free show of A Mediocre Time.
It's lit, fam! Let's do this!
Don't do that.
That's off the chain!
That's what the kids say. This is off the hizzy. Let's raise the roof.
Come on.
Let's do some roof raising today. That's what I say. Raise all the roofs.
Secured roof.
Secured roofing right. And restoration.fam.
They'll raise your roof.
They're lit, kid.
Welcome to A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I'm Tom.
I am Dan. Our producer, Samantha's here. Hello, Sam.
Hey, fun Friday.
It is a fun Friday. We were doing a little Remember When. If you've never joined us live on Twitch, you kind of missed out because I found some songs I'd been looking for. I found Dog Don't Bitch, that stupid song I wrote years ago. It's not stupid. I like the song. But I played it for the guys on Twitch ahead of time because I found it and I'd been looking for it, the master copy. I don't have a copy of that song, and I found one, so...
Old man plays his old song.
Old man. Yeah,
old days. Yeah. Glory days.
Well, it was either that or more gambling talk. I went with songs because it was
Get
him.
Demo men fight each other.
Well, I'm afraid I'm going to lose that one because this guy's strong as fuck.
Well,
he is
just roasting each other verbally.
As fuck.
Speaking of dumb old men,
yes, let's get into it. Let's do it.
We have some comfortable sweaters.
Oh my! Don't say sweaters.
We've got some comfortable.
Look at this cardigan.
You know, this is a value of a sweater I have right here. This is a nice.
It is comfortable as hell.
Yeah.
I have been so.
I can sleep in this.
I've been extra annoying this week because of the cold and chirpers when it's cold. If they like the cold, it's fine. If they dislike the cold, they go into full on baby mode. I'm in full on chirping. Baby mode where I tell you guys at least 50 times a day how much I hate the cold, how my fingers hurt, how my bones hurt, everything on me hurts. This has turned it all around. I needed was to bring a hoodie to the studio. Yeah. Our air conditioner's broke. I put it on 80, it goes to 62. I put it on 62, it goes to 41. I don't know what's happening. The Nest is out of control. Morad won't text us back. The water leak behind the door. Have you heard that? It's going crazy. There's a full waterfall behind my computer.
Don't go chasing them.
Full waterfall. That's AIDS, by the way.
Our rent got raised, too.
What?
Yeah. It went up.
A lot.
It's going up for everybody.
Yes. So that means BDM memberships are going up. $9. Even the $1.95 has become a $10.95. It's all going up.
So these hoodies will be for sale tonight. We'll let the BDMs know first as a perk of being a BDM. The text message will go out to anybody involved in our group text.
Yep.
And that's basically just our show number. If you text BDM, just BDM to that number, the show number, it'll opt you in. And then you'll find out about new merch releases and all the stuff. So
we don't have a ton of these, though, right?
No, I did not order as many as I should. Now that I see how nice they are, because I
knew it.
Well, they're also
said he's underestimating.
Okay. He's also done something that I've asked for years and never got. I've always wanted to do an athletic Heather sweatshirt, and this is the first time that Merchman came. When Merchman came in, I got a little sad because I'm like, we didn't order a lot of these, did we? Because they're really nice.
Well, we ordered
and we
two.
We took three of them.
I know. We'll give them back. This is just for promotion.
Wait a minute.
And then Eric's going to come back.
And here's something that Merchman, and man, you bigger guys out there, Merchman is looking out for you. He even was able to track down some 4Xs.
Nice.
Like he's working. Like he's hustling to try and make it so everybody gets thought of. So thank you, Eric, for all of your hard work, man.
But we
had much appreciated.
Too many of the last one. That's what made me gun shy about this one. I was like, hold on, we ordered too many of the last one. We had to discount them and sell them, which I never like doing.
They bought them all.
Yeah, but we had to discount them for what we paid for.
They were $50 hoodies.
And then it's like, well, then we're losing money with what we have to pay in shipping anyway. Hoodies will be for sale tonight.
Yes.
And the BDMs will know first.
Indeed.
So
what else? Any other little knickknack, paddywhack? We got stuff going on we can't tell you about.
Yeah.
I don't know why I said that. That's kind of a purposeless phrase. Don't do that. But I got a lot of stuff I can't tell you. I got a ton of stuff I can't tell
you. We could probably announce it on the next, not this BDM show that's coming up because we already recorded it, but the next BDM show in a couple weeks, we'll talk about it. It's something that we've been wanting to do for years, mm-hmm. and an opportunity came up, and then we're jumping on it, and it looks like we're full bore.
I can't keep it. We're buying.
Everything will be signed on Monday.
We're buying Carowinds. We're buying our own theme park.
So it's something that involves a property. I don't know. Okay. So
what are you doing?
We'll tell BDMs about it. So Super Bowl is this Sunday.
Yeah, you still having your swingers party?
Yeah,
aren't there kids involved?
I'm not calling it a swingers party.
They'll be in the playroom. You know, we'll keep any,
I thought you guys are going to be in the playroom.
We'll keep it. Well, we'll keep the action below the waterline, if you know what I mean. If, as long as I'm, you know.
Sam, you're invited.
Put a lot of suds in there.
You put a lot of.
You know why I don't tell Sam? Like, I don't officially invite Sam because
don't
I don't.
Say
fish. Yeah, I was thinking that. I'm like, why is he saying fish? No, you fish. And I have been linked up with pervertedness lately. But me and Sam are being extra dirty.
I said officially.
You did it again.
And it's because I feel awkward because then I feel like she's gonna feel like it's gonna hurt
my
feelings.
Who is the she?
Sam, like if I told her off the air, like, hey, do you want to come? Because it's only me, you, Tony Rage,
Tony
and
Monchette.
Our kids.
Monchette. Why can you not respect the man's name change?
And his pronouns.
Yeah.
Moonjet.
And it's they.
And
it's Tony they.
Then my kids, my mom may come over, and my niece.
I want to party with your mom.
She
sounds like a good time.
Man, but it's not. You get her chirping. Woo!
But it's not really.
She's a good chirper.
Like, I want.
Hey, how come you weren't chirpers? Your mom's a straight up chirping crazy.
Yeah,
she is like OG Florida chirper.
I know.
That's not fair.
Well,
that's not fair.
She chirped to me my entire life.
Oh,
so
it took the chirp out of them.
Well, yeah. It beat me down, so I grew to not like chirpers, but also. I'm a chirper at heart, so I can do this on the air.
Oh
but
God.
Off the air,
you
quiet.
You channel the
chirp. But just dead silent.
You're a chirp channeler.
I mean, I don't talk to you. I barely talk in this office.
I hate it.
But I just sit there in silence.
I'll be like, you want lunch? Well, you get like a grunt.
Anyway, so Sam, you are invited to the Super Bowl party, but I'm sure you got better plans.
No husbands. Sorry.
Why are you looking at your wife's pillow when you invite me over?
He has to. His wife has a rule where if he talks to
watching.
Any other woman, he has to look into the pillow's eyes.
So, but I'm sure you got a cooler party to go to with no kids.
I'm actually going to Twitch stream the Super Bowl. Like, so you know what happened in the last stream.
She saw the opening here. We said we're not going to do it anymore.
Yeah,
she saw the opening. She's like, Semantics Media, we're scooping that up. You found an opening. Kudos to you.
They were in there were commenting, so we're just doing the same work.
Take your top off.
Bits for
tits. What? Anyway,
and she could actually do it because she'll be there with her husband.
So
there's like safety involved. He might get topless.
So
a little something for the ladies.
For sure, probably be topless.
What
can guys' nipples be shown on Twitch? I gotta ask Juan some questions.
I think they can.
I believe they can.
Which is sexist.
Which is not fair. Yeah. But maybe if you guys didn't
promote
have
your
such
Twitch channel.
Like long nipples, you know it's your
long
fault.
Nipples.
Yeah, I mean if you think about it, our nipples are closer to our chest. I mean, you guys have a little more, you know, a little more 3D action going on there.
They're meant for feeding a human.
Yeah.
Anyway, what's your Twitch Samantha?
Channel? Did you just say Samantha? Twitch.tv/SemanticsMedia.
Semantics Media. Yep. And you can watch them stream the Super Bowl. That'll be fun.
We're going to be giving away some free Semantics shirts during that Twitch stream.
Very cool.
So speaking of the Super Bowl, I was I'm making a better effort.
You were drunk.
I'm not drunk. I think it's time to cut back a little bit. There's a whole story. I'll tell the BDOs.
Yeah.
My cholesterol, I don't know why.
Didn't tell any of that, but you didn't want me to get scared. Yeah. I feel like he hides a lot from me. I feel like I am dying. Well, I can't tell Daniel.
So anyway.
He'll get triggered.
I'm making a better effort to talk to my sons while I drive because I made the joke to Daniel, like, we drive in dead silence. The whole way, they get in the car, we drive to school, we stop at, there's 3 stoplights, and then, and they're like probably 10 turns, and no one talks. Dead silent? Then I say, bye, I love you, and then
I will tell you that 3 stoplights and 10 turns to Maisie is an entire conversation. Maybe 3 conversations. She does not shut up. In fact, one of the things I wrote in there, and I didn't even want to talk about it because we've been going heavy on the chirp, is that Maisie chirped me so good to the point where I had to tell her, you need to shut up. I said that is a quote. I said, May, you got to shut up. I had something.
I think that's normal for kids.
I think so, yeah.
I had something at the studio happening that was going wrong. I had a file that I was messed up, and I was trying to get with KC, and mm-hmm. you know what yeah, I'm talking yeah. about, and I was trying to link it up. And May was standing by. What are you doing? Well, there's a file for corporate. Is that your
what
radio
kind
show?
Of file?
Yeah, that's the when Mr. Tom. Yeah, what do you guys talk about? Well, on tonight's show, I don't know. We had Kratom Carey. What's Kratom? what's Carey? Who's Carey?
Yeah, all
and
the questions.
And I'm like, oh my god! Yeah. And I looked at her, and I don't feel I'm not proud of myself, but I said, you got to shut up. You just got to stop. And then Andrea's like, oh, come over here. You know, we'll do something. And then I fixed it. But I would give.
It's so funny.
I would rip off all my fingernails. I would rip off every fingernail, not have them grow back, to have one car ride to school where I just got a night drinking my coffee. Maybe we're listening to some music, a little pleasantries.
Everything is you want what you don't have.
Oh, yeah.
100%. Because I would love for my sons to express any interest into my work or anything that I'm doing or ask me any question. I would love to talk to them about anything. Tell them, like, I try to. So, anyway.
You just want to tell them your stories, man.
Yeah, I know.
I feel bad.
And they don't want to hear it. So I told my wife this, and Crystal was like, well, you have to engage in conversation. It's like, we talked the whole ride home. She picks the kids up from school. I drop them off.
But their relationship is different. And I hate it when they do that, too, because Andrea will do that, too. Like, whatever I want, I'm not getting. Mm. She'll just say, well, you need to do this. It works for me. And I'm like, yeah, of course it works for you. You're an elevated human being.
Yeah, so she tells me, like, well, I talked to him, and they talked to me the whole time on
that's
the ride home.
That's just said
school.
To make you feel bad, by
I
the way.
Don't, I don't.
Like, you don't need
well,
to
I don't feel it. Bad. And then I'm like, well, shit, I'm doing it wrong. Like I need to talk to my sons. So I've been trying to start
what's
chirping
up, bro?
At them.
It's Limp Bizkit. You used to do what I started the show with.
And this morning, I started just talking to them about the Super Bowl. I'm like, hey, boys, you know, Super Bowl's this weekend. They're like, yeah. And then I'm like, yeah, we're going to have a party. Mr. Daniel, Maisie's coming over,
yeah,
Mr. Tony.
I'm making queso.
Yeah, yeah.
I make homemade queso. I got a double broiler or whatever, where I put the glass bowl on top of it. I'm going to gently melt the cheese and use, like, cream.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah,
like
you want me to smoke it? I can smoke the queso, yeah, too.
Do whatever you I yeah. Anything you bring.
It's already starting to sound better.
Yeah, come yeah. on over. I'd like to cook it up big. Andrea said, you don't need to do much, you know. No.
Well, that's why I want to do something extraordinary, not just do the three medium pizzas.
We're not doing it. No, right. I'm making homemade queso. I got a few other things up my sleeve.
So I start chirping at my sons, talking about the Super Bowl, right? So then I go through basically who's playing in the Super Bowl, who they want to win.
Who's playing?
And then I get to halftime show, right? And so, and they're like, what's the halftime show? I'm like, you know, when they take a break, there's four quarters and there's a halftime. And, you know, it's extended during the Super Bowl because they do a big concert.
Yeah. Mary released a new song today.
Don't
sleep on it. Don't sleep on it. Go grab that new Mary. Grab the new Mary. That's Dan's tip of the week.
So then I'm like, you know, and the performers of the Super Bowl, they were super popular when Daddy was in high school, whatever, and they're like, okay.
Oh,
they
man.
Exactly don't give
why
a fuck.
my 7-Eleven ladies listen to conservative radio, just to help you out. They were straight S dunking on the, they were shitting on it sideways.
Wow.
On the Super Bowl?
On the
halftime
show. It was a dumb white guy and a dumb white girl, and they were old shitting. I mean,
So
straight saying how it's not going to be good, low energy. They should get people.
Low energy.
They said that this is a dip down, that they were used to the Super Bowls where they had iconic and legendary rockers like Tom Petty and Prince. I'll give you Prince, but Tom Petty was the most boring bullshit I've ever seen.
I love Tom Petty, but yeah, that was boring.
I love Tom Petty too.
Old man,
that's not the right show. Yeah. Now, Prince, all day long.
Right.
NSYNC, all day long. Britney Spears, every year.
Gaga.
That's my vote. Britney Spears, every year until she dies.
Gaga,
every
Madonna.
Year until she dies. Madonna, Katy Perry. Yeah, anyway.
So,
Doja Cat.
So anyway, I'm like.
She just did a cover of Celebrity Skin by Hole that came out today. Grab that. I believe it's Doja Cat.
Like,
look that up too. That's it. That's a good one.
Sometimes I'm surprised by what my sons know because they're roaming the internet, unwatched. They'll know something that I'm like, you know that? Anyway, so I'm like, you know, Snoop Dogg is performing. They're like, what? And I'm like, Snoop Dogg.
Is that a G thing, Daddy?
No. They're like, Snoopy? And then I'm like, no. His name is Snoop Dogg. And then also Eminem. And they're like, Eminem's? And then it dawned on me. I'm like, they have stupid baby names. If you think about it.
Yeah.
Your son sounded like there's two conservative hosts on the radio. So they're like, Snoopy Dog, yeah, and M&M's are stupid.
But then it never occurred to me that they do have stupid baby names. And I was like, you know what, sons, you're right. Their names are stupid baby names. Yeah. And then I stopped talking, drove in school. Silence got out.
But silence is golden.
Like, Snoopy and M&M. Anyway, so then when last night I started looking through all the props, right? And speaking of Snoop Dogg, you know, the Super Bowl has the most props of any game, and like, you know, that's part of the whole thing.
Right.
People just gamble on the ridiculous stuff, coin toss, and the commercials, and there's hundreds and hundreds of them, right? So I started looking through some of the dumb ones, right? And I get to a halftime. They have the whole one, like, will Eminem wear a hat or a hoodie? You could bet
right.
on all that stuff.
Yeah.
The color of Snoop Dogg's shoes, you could bet on that.
Who will come out first to sing? Will they all be on the stage
I
at the
really
same time?
Hope,
they're backup dancers. Yeah.
I really hope that Eminem does not wear his Fidel Castro military
he
hat.
He will.
I hate those hats.
I think the thing is glued on now.
Is it because?
I've never seen
missing
it. I think he might be losing.
Okay,
the hair, the bleach
between
might
the
ruined.
Weirdo beardo, and look, I don't like sitting here just disassembling this man's appearance, but I just think if he had just regular hair and just came out as Eminem, no matter what he wears, he'd be fine. But for some reason, it's hard for me personally to get past the beard in the Fidel Castro hat. I can't. It's weird.
This year, since we're having mostly sans, maybe like Kendrick Lamar, like mostly old school hip hop and R&B. What if next year we go? Straight up new metal.
Mumble. Oh.
Fucking Limp Bizkit, Korn, like Family Value Store. Come on, give it to me.
I'd be into it because I just made my wife so happy that I was able to use this gift I gave her to lead to intimacy. She didn't know that the new Limp Bizkit album is straight fucking awesome.
Yeah.
Andrea didn't know that the newest Limp Bizkit.
It's
really good. If you like, you got it for what it is, right? Limp Bizkit on their newest album that came out months ago.
It's
exactly the formula of Nookie, right?
Don't change it.
Every song's a Nookie. And you put it on, and I played it for Andrea, and she goes, wow. She goes, this is really good. And then she told a friend at work, and he said to later, he's like, wow, this is really good. Like, she's getting, like, compliments now on, like, suggesting the new Limp Bizkit album.
Really?
Because it's just what it needs to be. He did the Mark McGrath. Fred Durst did the Mark McGrath.
Give them what they want.
He said, you know what? We're the best at doing this style, this like rap metal. We are the best. I'm just going to take that formula. I'm going to write a bunch of songs that are very much based on that vibe. I have the original lineup. I think Otto's drumming for him again. Wes Borland's back. Everybody's original except for maybe one person, I think. It's the core band, and then they put it. It's good.
It's called Still Sucks.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say
Limp Bizkit.
Do you want to hear a little bit of it?
Like the fact that he dresses up like an old man and stuff.
Oh,
no,
I love it.
I don't think he dresses up. That's how he looks.
No, he buys wigs and he does.
I know,
on TikTok.
But have you seen him lately? It's like he's becoming the thing.
I love it. Yeah.
But it's a it's a joke, or like he's kind of
it's a
making
bit.
Fun of himself. Yeah, yeah.
It's a really fun record. This is the one I played for. I'll play the one I played for Andrea. This is the single, I think. Dad Vibes. Did you hear? You haven't heard any of this, have you?
No. Okay. I didn't even know they had a
this
new
is the,
album.
Came out on Halloween.
Yeah, it came out on Halloween. This is the here is the single Dad Vibes. You're going right back to the 90s.
Check out your dad with the swag on the floor. Mama going brag when I walk in the door. Y'all ain't never seen a gorilla in the mist walk the line so fine with a blindfold.
It's the same shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love it.
And then it goes hard soon.
We'll get there, and then I'll fade it out.
Okay.
See? You're just supposed to bounce to it.
Yeah. This is all for a bunch of 40-year-olds. You know,
yeah.
Used to listen,
how
right?
dare you? I'm not 40. That's you.
Yeah. What I'm just saying is like that genre. Like now you just mix dad in there. They're like, all right, that's everybody's a dad now.
Here's what I know. My 38-year-old wife, about to turn 39, was shaking her tits all over the place with that song. It's good. Just take it for what it is. Right. It's not going to win a Grammy.
No.
Yeah, but yeah. It'll certainly make you slap your mammy. Back to you, Sam.
So back to the gambling.
Yes.
So I look at, and then I ran across this prop, and then I was like, this is free money. And I'll explain. So the prop is Snoop Dogg to smoke on stage.
Mm-hmm.
Yes or no? Now,
there's a lot of.
This changed overnight, which kind of concerns me.
Smoke.
So
I mean, if he pulls out like a Marlboro Wide, you know, or Camel Wides and starts smoking a cigarette, does that count?
It does. Anything he's smoking will count. So. He's not. So anyway, at the time last night, it was yes, minus 105, no, minus 125. So, of course, I'm looking at no and I'm like, man, this is seems like free money. This line is way too light and small. This should be like minus 275 because I feel like there's no fucking way he smokes a blunt mm-hmm. or a cigarette or smokes anything on stage, given the NFL and how much advertising and how big this game is and the history of the halftime shows in the NFL.
What happened yesterday after the big virtual press conference with Goodell? He released a statement saying the NFL as a whole has to, quote, do better. Smoking weed on stage, not doing better,
yes.
Right? That so, plays into it. That's what I was going on. So I am with you in saying that he will not smoke weed on stage because the NFL is under the microscope right now for looking shitty.
Hmm.
And what he further confirmed that I think I'm on the right direction. Now, here's the thing. In every bet, and this is what professional bettors look at, there's no guarantee to anything. You don't know the future. You there's no guarantees, right? But there are percentages.
Who knows about the future? That's anybody's guess. That ain't no reason for getting all depressed.
You're just betting the odds, and I'm telling you that minus 125 is great number for no, right? Now, there's max bets on these stupid props. I could only
you should have named your kid that. I've always thought that. Every time you say it, I'm like, if he just made a max bets van.
So on Bovada, I can only bet $60 to win 50. Now, here's my only concern. It went down overnight, and I checked on it this morning. It was minus 115. So it's even better odds, and you can get down more money. Now, I don't know what the max bet is on your particular offshore book, but you could check it out. I'm just saying Snoop Dogg to not smoke on stage. And think about it. Like, the NFL, there's too many, like, in. So I put this up on the Medium gambling page, and
what were they saying? Like, so you
they were like, no, I think he does because it's they're like, in California, it's legal. That's his brand.
We are the only two people saying he will not. Everybody else I have asked has said he will.
But that's a great. That's what the public think, and that's why the line's so small. They're like, but you're not
because
thinking,
he always does at his concert.
He always does.
Now, I have seen him.
The NFL
once.
Will never let him do it.
I've seen him once in concert, and he did in fact light up on stage.
That's he did when I saw him.
Yes, that's his thing. But the problem is,
no, I understand. But that's why everyone thinks he will.
Yes, and that's why it's a great edge in this
the
bet.
Edge,
I'm telling
I
you,
I think I finally
it's
get it.
Free
now.
Money to bet no on this. He's not going to smoke on stage. They'll never approve that. Can you imagine the meme of him smoking weed on stage and then it going out on the internet to all the fucking Midwest and religious people? Like, the world is bigger.
All you would have to do is have on one side a picture of Snoop lighting up, on the other side that picture of Roger Goodell on the call saying we have to do better, and say, does this look better? You know, that's what they do,
right? Because they're getting a bunch of heat because Alvin Kamara is punching someone and then there's a bunch of DUIs and shit, and they hate that shit, right?
Deadly.
So
DUI.
The last thing they're going to let, so now you're thinking, okay, well, Snoop is going to sneak it Snoop is a 50-year-old businessman now,
man.
And he's not going to do anything that would cause him bad relationship with the NFL. Why the fuck would you do that with your business career, right? He's too old and too smart at this point.
Everybody's still saying in the chat room, he's going to smoke. He's
going to
smoke.
It's a great bet. No smoke. It's free money. This is coming from Tom. It's free. Bet no.
Oh, Sam looks concerned.
Uh-oh. So anyway.
Is it out? This Roger is, Goodell? Is that him?
What is this?
Oh, wait,
who Snoop
is it?
Dogg?
Is it our boss?
It's Snoop Dogg.
Hey, what's up for Shizzo?
Long tail?
Is this a horse dog?
Hello? Can you hear us, sir? Hello?
Trying the other line now.
Was it?
Hello, can you hear us, sir?
There he is.
Hey, Dan, how are you?
Is this horse racing Doug?
Yes, sir.
Hey, good to talk to you, man. You're just the guy we need to talk to. Snoop Dogg lighting up on stage.
Absolutely. And listen, Tom, you're right, I believe. But I think you're right for a different reason. I'm 54, and I think Snoop got to be pushing 60, right?
No, he actually just turned 50.
Yeah, he's the same age as Eminem, which is
yeah.
Weird.
And everybody makes that common mistake because he started when he was like 17. And we forget how young he was when he started. But yeah, I think he's just turned 50. Yeah. But he's been in the entertainment business for, since 25 years.
Since he was 17, 18.
Yeah. Okay, my point is, though, is he's got all these corporate sponsors going on right now. And, you know, I listened to the Howard Stern show as well, and even Howard Stern brought it up. He goes, there's no way Snoop is going to smoke on stage and ruin those corporate sponsors.
Well, who's he been working with lately? Anybody know? Who's he been working with? Where's he been the most visible?
Doesn't he have that NBC sports
thing? Bingo. Yeah. NBC with Kevin Hart, the biggest network, one of the biggest, with one of the biggest, if not the biggest comedian, right up there with Chappelle, except he's the more, I guess, commercial version of that, right? I don't know. Does that play into it? I would think
he's not going to do
it. He's not going to do it. He has too much on the line. He has some really big partnerships. I think he also has a book, a gambling book. Like he's doing commercials for a...
And I know he has his own weed brand and stuff, and you may be like, oh, he wants to promote that. But he's not going to be able to promote that. So it's just smoking a blunt on stage is going to get him in all types of trouble with the NFL. They're going to be pissed.
Hold on. What did my wife just dump in the chat room? She dumped some TMZ article that says 2 Chainz Snoop Dogg smoke weed Super Bowl halftime. Did they already do it?
Well, the line changed. I got scared because I already bet it. And if I'm fucking wrong, I lost
2 Chainz is suggesting to Snoop Dogg that he should smoke one on stage.
No, 2 Chainz. Yeah, what are you doing? No, that's all part of it. 2 Chainz got a new album out, by the way. This dope ain't going to sell itself. I think that's
why the line changed too. Because people started. That's why the line changed. This is how it works. Like, people started just betting on he will smoke on stage
because 2 Chainz suggested it. Of course he won't do it now. Oh, this is free money. We're on it.
Perfect for minus 115. You bet $115 to win 100.
2 Chainz stated his case, bringing up the fact that marijuana is legal in California, and told our cam. He tried to call Snoop to convince him to do it.
Well, that sounds like he's already not going to
do it.
Because the NFL.
Oh, this is good info. So why are people continuing to bet yes when 2 Chainz confirmed?
Because
that
people
Snoop
are stupid.
Is leading no.
Because that's the public. You bet against
and
the public.
What is this thing about people saying that Snoop or Eminem would pull their dick out during halftime?
Have you heard this? Yeah.
Why are people thinking that was the thing that was going to happen?
Because people are stupid. The internet's stupid.
That's a real thing.
Yes.
You can bet on it.
And Dr. Dre had to come out and say, like, officially, like, yeah, that's definitely not happening.
This is not real.
I swear.
Dr. Dre had to have a press conference to say that Eminem and Snoop are going to pull their dicks out.
There's a bet. Will there be a wardrobe malfunction, right?
There's that one too, yeah.
And of course there won't, but the
Mary J's titty comes out.
Hey.
It ain't going to happen.
They do bounce around on stage.
It ain't going to happen.
I think she is so fucking hot.
Yeah.
God almighty, one night with Mary J. Come on, little Danny, let me climb the mountains.
And to further argue my point, from the 2000, was it one Super Bowl or 2002 Super Bowl, the wardrobe malfunction with Janet Jackson? I think it was 04.
Because, it was like junior or senior in high school.
Was it 04?
It was 2004.
I have no concept of time.
But the NFL got so much shit for that. That was such a pain in the ass that they won't allow
everybody
spontaneous shit like that ever again. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They're going to tell all the performers, like, hey, don't do it. We'll fucking sue you. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure they assign that.
Well, if you'll remember, that's why that Lady Gaga jumping from the roof looked so fucking stupid, is because everything was, like, pre-taped and they had to have this thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, and then it makes it, when you kill that spontaneity, it just becomes like a pre-taped piece of garbage.
I'm telling you, and they're twice as big as they used to be. The NFL's making more money than ever. They got more sponsors than ever. There's no fucking way Snoop Dogg smokes anything on stage. No way. And it's almost, I would put it up near damn 80% chance that I'm right. Like, if that's how, you're getting minus 115.
This isn't a prop bet that I saw or anything, but will they have any marijuana imagery?
No.
No.
No, they
hell
can't.
No.
They okay. can't.
They may have some smoke on
that
stage
would actually
to, like,
be worse.
Tip of the cap.
That would actually be worse than him lighting up, because you can argue, oh, he's having a hand-rolled cigarette versus sure. a big pot leaf waving
right,
in
right,
the breeze.
Right.
They're making like $1 billion in advertising. There's no way they fuck
that's
around with
question,
anything.
Though.
You know, it's now they just are now are dipping their toe into gambling and FanDuel and so, but they're a while away from marijuana, and because there are other.
Oh,
everybody
do you
forgets
still have that set list. Sorry, Tom, yeah. do you still have
I
that?
I can pull
set?
It up.
Yeah, pull up the set list because I want to see if.
See,
it,
I don't know how accurate it is
accurate.
Though, because there are prop bets on what song will be played first. I'm like, why wouldn't everyone just Google that?
It's
and,
probably
like,
a leak, like a calculated leak. I've known that bands now recently, in order to throw things off,
yeah.
they'll almost throw out a "This is our set list for the night," full knowing that they're going to change it.
And they just set the limits on what you could bet, so they make it like you could only bet $30 on that, even though if you know it for sure. So what? And then they'll make it -250 that's the first song.
Oh,
and, you know.
Interesting! It's gone. It's removed now. They, it just says TBD now.
Yeah.
Did you screenshot it at all?
No.
Oh,
damn.
But that's
I'll have to go back and listen to that ACT.
That's been happening for a year. Like right before the game, some janitor or someone in the stadium will listen to the rehearsal and time it, the national anthem rehearsal,
yeah, yeah.
and then they'll put it out, and you'll see the lines change like 15 minutes before.
Nothing but a G-thing.
Or yeah, but like it'll get leaked out, but then they'll just they'll change the odds, lower the limit, so it doesn't matter to them. It's all like they want you to bet. They don't care if you lose $30 here or there. Or
Christine
whatever.
In our Twitch chat room brings up an excellent selection. Are they going to end with California Love? It would be smart to, right?
That was, I do remember that was what it was in the list that we saw. They were supposed to end on California Love, which then I said, are they going to have Tupac hologram at the end? Which is also a prop bet. I don't know if you saw that Tupac hologram.
I think it'd be funnier if they got a little person to play Tupac and had him come out and lip sync.
Little Tupac.
Little
yeah.
Tupac.
Yeah, yeah.
Lil. Remember when everything was Lil? You had like the real and then you'd have a Lil.
I still don't think they're messing around with holograms anymore. Like,
what if they have the... Okay, what if they had a hologram of Snoop Dogg smoking weed?
They won't have that either. I don't know that bet. You have to read the fine print in a lot of these books. It'll say like, you know, some what doesn't count. But I don't think there's any smoking at all. Because the NFL don't want it. There's too much money.
Yeah. I just think it's not the image they want to portray. And they've been in so much trouble the past 2 weeks. And I think the nail in the coffin, if even Snoop was going to chance it. And somebody in the chat room, I forget who it was. I'd have to scroll back. They brought up something that you and I didn't think about. But this is a big one that plays into it. Snoop takes NFL football extremely seriously. He does not screw around.
He loves football.
He's a coach. He takes kids coaching seriously.
There's so many kids. He's not going to smoke weed. There's too many kids
it's
watching.
Too important to him. I think him performing there is, if you were to ask him, he might say, this is why I've been doing this, is for this.
Yeah, yeah.
To perform at a Super Bowl. I love football. This is like the in LA. Come on, right? Why would he do something to tarnish that? He knows that this kind of thing, this kind of stuff, especially now with the way that the world is with social media, can spiral out of control so quickly.
Yeah.
You know, this was years ago when Janet Jackson and that whole Janet Jackson and Justin Timberlake deal like popped off. I mean, if it happened now, it's going to be 10 times worse, right?
Yeah, he ain't doing it. Mm-mm. I'm telling you. And
I think we figured out a good one.
I forgot that point. There's so many kids watching, too, that even
But everybody knows Snoop Dogg smokes weed. It's not like it's going to shock the kids.
Yeah, but I'm talking the NFL. This is not a televised Snoop Dogg concert only. That's different. This is the halftime show of the NFL. This is the fucking NFL show. So they're like, Snoop Dogg isn't fucking with that. And there's... They didn't approve it, and he ain't doing it like a rogue saying fuck you to the NFL, because why would he do that business-wise? Anyway.
Okay.
Only other bet, before we do some voicemail email, is a lot of people don't know this, but the opening kickoff of the game, they use a commemorative football, because every single opening kickoff of every Super Bowl is in the Hall of Fame. So it's that.
That's pretty cool.
So the ball is like has the Super Bowl stuff on it, whatever. It's a brand new football. So since they use that ball in the opening kickoff, it's harder than their normal balls that they use. So it always comes up short, and then therefore is not a touchback, because everybody's used to touchbacks. Right?
This is a piece of football trivia I never knew.
This is,
you are becoming weird.
So you can bet, and there's a bet, a prop bet on there, will the opening kickoff be a touchback? And a lot of people know the word's out, so it's minus 165 on the no. But still, it's happened. I think the last touchback in the Super Bowl was like 2014 or something. So it's been not a touchback for 7 years straight. Plus, I think there's a little bit of an NFL telling them like, hey, let's let them run it back for the first kickoff so it's more exciting because touchbacks are boring. Anyway,
I never knew any of this.
There's two little tips.
All right, I like that.
Rams to call the first time out too. That's
the other one you've been heavy on. Yeah, McVay does not value timeouts the way that other coaches may be. So those are your Tom tips.
Yeah, shortest touchdown under 1.5. Sorry.
Was that a shot?
I'll put him up on the BDM.
Is that something about me?
No.
Is that what you call me around here, the shortest touchdown?
I know. It's
more like a safety. 2-point conversion, maybe.
Let's do some voicemail email.
Oh, mail on mail. That's what we call it. I forgot we even have an intro for that.
Hey guys, thanks for calling 1-800-HOT-DICK, the place to find real action with real men. To make it even better, we've got new low prices. So low, we're practically giving it away free.
If you are a man seeking a woman, press 1. If you are a woman seeking a man, press 2. If you are a man seeking a man, press 3. If you
are male on male.
Male on male. Speaking of Snoop Dogg, it's brought to you by TrueLeave. If you want something,
I got new stuff right here. I'll show it, but this is the newest. This is a mini, like a little guy.
Oh, cool.
It's like a little mini pen deal that you can pick up. Wow. If you want to remember when we were talking to Skylar from TrueLeave, she was saying that you can try things.
Yeah,
they make them in smaller portions so you can go in there. You don't have to pony up for like a gram or something like that. That's one of the new colors additions, and this one is strawberry lemonade. Have yet to try it. I'll report back.
And whatever you buy at TrueLeave, you go on TomandDan.com, fill out the form, and we will mail you a free TrueLeave beanie and some other Tom and Dan stuff, sticker. I know we have the BDM front license plate we've been sending out. All that free, if just all you have to do is take a picture of what you bought at TrueLeave and submit it in the form. Your receipt, a picture, it, you know, everybody gets it, and you can do it once a month, so you can constantly get free stuff mailed to you, and it helps us out because we show it to TrueLeave, and like, hey, they're responding, and that's it. Simple as that.
It's a pretty organic relationship. Yeah. Like
you we buy weed, we give you free gifts.
Yeah, and then I go there, like people think that we get like the ultimate hookup. We don't. I go there, I buy new products like this so I can try it, so I can tell you guys if I like it or not.
Yeah,
It's a very easy, breezy relationship, so shout out to TrueLeave and to Skylar. We love those guys.
The form is on TomandDan.com. Should we start off with...
Let's go email, because we got a bunch of emails this week.
Hey, show. So you've heard of the Oviedo chickens, and maybe even the legend of the Oviedo lights. The green ghostly headlights from a speeding dead trucker who appears when you drive over the bridge crossing the Econ after midnight.
Oh, I've never heard of that one either.
That's
almost like the black dot from that movie that Randy Travis and Meatloaf were in.
What?
Black Dog.
Oh, yeah.
There was a trucker movie called Black Dog, and then, like, if you were driving late at night, sometimes if a black dog ran across your path, you'd wreck your 18-wheeler because you didn't have any more meth, and...
Yeah, it's like you're hallucinating.
The hooker that was riding with you to the next town would die, or something.
But now, Oviedo has a new legend. The Oviedo Dick Monster.
Tom. That's you.
Mentioned in a podcast my daughter listened to about cryptids, the rare Oviedo dick monster has upended my life. The legends tell of a 7-foot-tall, quote, fully erect penis with legs for testicles roaming in Oviedo neighborhoods at night, seeking and only ever being seen by teenagers smoking marijuana.
Stupid.
This is either highly amusing or terrifying, since a shadowy shack-sized penis waddling towards you in the night on its bulbous testy legs is a mental image I can't shake. So shout out to the stoners in the Stillwater neighborhood, you brave, brave, stupid souls.
Well, they didn't even make it like anything like scary. Slightly believable. You know, like Slender Man to me is terrifying. And that video game that I downloaded years ago, that app, the Slender Man game, you could download it for like the iPhone. And you'd be like in a forest on your little viewer there, and then you'd see a house in the distance, and it would tell you, like, walk for the house. So you'd walk towards the house, and then sometime, no matter, like, you'd start playing, like, 2 minutes or so. And yeah. no matter what, Slenderman would appear, and then he'd just keep walking towards you, and you couldn't stop him. And right. it was just terrifying for some reason. Just the look of him, the way he looks, him appearing in pictures. I get all of that. But this is just a joke.
It's got to be, right? Because, like, in Miami when we were kids, it was Chupacabra was a big one.
But they actually had people that went to lengths to make us believe in that. Like, goats with actual...
Are these chickens
I've seen the videos where they take a goat, and I'm assuming that the person who's making the video took a screwdriver and stabbed it twice in the neck and then made it look like a vampire, like, sucked its blood. You know? Like, they do things to make it look believable, right? There is no such thing as a Chupacabra.
No. But I always thought it was a goat that was like a vampire with teeth.
No, okay, you would eat the goat.
All right, so it's just a monster of some sort.
Yeah,
you know,
Chupacabra like a
what is it?
Half dog, half cat. It was like cat dog, Nickelodeon's cat dog.
I thought it was a goat with vampire, and then it was like the vampire goat.
It could be. Why would it eat other goats though?
It was eating
you
chickens.
You look like me.
Maybe the goat sucker, right? Chupacabra?
No, goat sucker meaning it sucked the goats.
Oh.
Not that it was a goat sucker.
Anyway, even when I was a kid, it was stupid to me. But Bigfoot, Sasquatch, all the stuff like...
Yeah, it can be translated as goat sucker.
So it was a monster that sucked the blood of the goats. Yeah, yeah. A lot of goats in Miami. It's chickens too, you know.
Yeah.
But
I like chickens, I like goats. I like cars, I like boats.
But anyway, it was at least you're like, well, is it some sort of animal that is able to hide and like feed off? You know, like there was the walking dick is stupid. There's, you know,
I'm picturing
no
that.
One's scared of a 7 foot walking dick.
What's that?
I mean, I would be.
But you're not going to believe it.
I don't
it.
Think I would be either. I'm picturing like those inflatable T-Rex costumes.
Yeah, yeah,
that's
yeah.
what I'm picturing.
And I figured
that like, are very popular. Well, they were popular like 5 years ago. The brown or orange brown inflatable T-Rex costume. That's what I'm picturing.
Because, okay, when you were a teenager and there was always the urban legend about something that was going to kill you, Slender Man, Chupacabra,
I'm trying to think what we had. We had Bigfoot, we had the Barton Booger, we had like Swamp Cabbage Man.
But it was always like
Swamp Ape.
Something
that Swamp Ape.
Was dangerous. And that was the thing that was scary. The big dick is like, what are they saying? It waddled towards you and what?
Yeah.
Jizzes in your face.
Yeah, jizzes in your face, man.
Glues your eyelids shut.
That's not going to kill you. It's not going to hurt you. Yeah, unless it had AIDS. That would be bad. What happened to you, man? A long death. I got AIDS. What is it? The Oviedo dick monster.
If you didn't have any cuts, you're fine.
Yeah. how'd you get AIDS from it? Well, I had unprotectedly scared me.
So is this just teenagers fucking around and trolling?
Yes. It's a bunch of high teenagers. And they saw giant dick walking around.
But it's a joke. They're not even meaning it to be serious. I don't even know why anybody's even taking this as being serious. Like, to me, if my daughter came up to me like, do you hear about the 7 foot tall dick monster? I'd be like, get your mind out of the gutter. What the fuck's wrong with you, Maisie? I would. I'd be like, what the fuck? That's like some shit I would say. Why are you acting like me? Get the fuck out of here. Act like your mom. That's what I would say. I'd be like, that sounds like some stupid shit that Daniel says. Tell me that doesn't sound like some stupid shit I would say. A 7 foot tall dick monster that lives in Oviedo?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's right on brand for me.
And you're like, does it walk on its balls or its balls its legs?
Well, it has a one wheel.
Why 7 foot? Many questions.
I got to bring up something. This is completely unrelated, but I mentioned one wheel. I wanted to buy you a 40th birthday gift. And I remembered back to my 40th birthday when you bought me a drone.
Yeah, yeah.
And I decided that I was going to purchase you from my savings account a one wheel XR.
Okay.
And
right.
I was going to buy it for you. And
the GT is a new one, so you know.
But my wife.
The XR is the
old
one.
For the
GT.
One.
The GT. Oh, yeah. I want to get you
the new one.
And then my wife said, no, you need to ask Crystal first because she might want to buy it for.
No, she's not buying nothing.
She ain't buying it.
And I said, well,
I counted on this. I was like, I bet Daniel buys me one wheel.
I will buy it right now.
But then I was like, well, buy it.
I will buy it right now in the studio. But my wife told me no. And then she asked me to ask Sam about it. And then I woke up this morning.
Ask me about it.
What is Sam going to say?
Say, do I need to? Because my wife was like, well, I guess you might be right. It is a gift, and you shouldn't have to ask other people to give gifts to people you care about. And I go, there you go. I'm buying it for him. And she's like, well, just clear it with Sam first to see what she thinks. That's what my wife said. And then I started typing Sam last night. I got too high and passed out. So here we are.
Use the company money. Don't use your own money.
No, right? I was going to use my own money.
I bought your 40th birthday present with the company's money.
Oh, the truth comes out.
Yeah, but and it wasn't expensive as a one wheel.
Yeah, like, your one was like $3,800. God damn.
I was like,
this is like I'm buying a smart car at the Mercedes-Benz dealership down there. It's like buying a used truck.
Yeah. I got you like a version one beginner drone, $380.
But I wanted to get you something good.
That I appreciate
But here's the problem with Tom. He's only into one thing, one wheel, and his boys. And I can't buy you sons.
Or gambling, yeah.
I can't buy you any gambling. I guess I could give you what you gave me for the drone in money and be like, no, here, buddy, blow that in some gambling.
Listen.
But I thought it would be more fun to get you a one wheel because I know nobody else is going to root for you.
That is
and
fun.
And I know nobody else is going to get it for you, so.
No, now, Crystal, I
well, I'm getting it for you.
She didn't give me nothing.
Well, that's what you're getting. It's just going to take a while because they're on back order.
No.
But I'm getting you a one wheel.
Well, I mean, that's pretty awesome.
Happy 40.
Okay, I feel like now I got to get you something better.
No, don't get me anything. Yeah. I'll be dead soon. Well, don't worry about me.
Well, wait until your 50th. Then I'll get you something real good.
Hopefully you give me a new wife. My 50th. Because I don't know how I'm going to pull off this buying you the one wheel thing because I have no access to my money. I gotta figure that part out.
You need the money. You need money.
I'm like falling down into the bank safe. I'm gonna figure out a way to get the money.
All right.
I don't have enough in my secret PayPal that Andrew doesn't know about. My secret PayPal, though, I had commandeered all of that money for VR bangers and for a new one that a listener turned me on to called Wanks VR.
Is that the British version?
Dude, Wanks VR, the pussy is, I'm telling you.
Tickling your nose.
I almost swatted my headset off because I was like lacing linen right on my face. She was like right in my face. I could even see one hair on her butthole.
No,
she didn't
come
share.
On. No,
shave.
No.
There was one long butt hair. That shit's so good.
No. One I don't want to be that close. No,
I don't want to see the hair. Yeah.
You can't smell it? It's like the best of both worlds. It's the best of both worlds.
Oh, smell-o-vision.
No, I don't want that. I want to be able to stare at it without going, damn, that's like come on. That's like orange juice. It's got some acid. It's got acid to it. That's like limit. That's like key lime juice. Burning my eyes.
Let's do some voicemail.
All right. let's try.
This is the last Friday show on my third.
Tilton Head BDM here. You know, you got this guy calling and whining about paper straws at McDonald's. But am I the only one here? Like, just who cares? Like, pick up the cup and drink from it like a regular human being. Why do we all need straws? When did this come about that everyone needs a straw for every fucking drink they get? I don't get it. Just take the lid off. Christ.
I'm with this guy for the longest time. The only reason I've been using straws lately is because when you go to a restaurant, they'll give you straws. Or I hate it when they already have them out of the wrapper because I'm like, well, you're wasting that because I don't use straws. And for the longest time, up until we had Maisie, I was anti-straw. I just drank out of a cup. No matter what, I always drink out of a cup. And I would say straws are for babies. That was like a joke. like, I don't need a straw. A cup is just fine.
Yeah, and it's the argument against drinking out of the cup.
Why
is
are we
stupid.
A straw society?
I like straws.
Well, my wife was like, don't drink out of the cup. It's gross. Drink out of the straw. I'm like, the liquid's in the cup.
Thank
like,
you. What this man, right?
That's
here.
Not my reasoning. I don't know. I just prefer a straw.
Yeah. I mean, just drink out of the cup. And like, you put it in the dishwasher or whatever. What is it going to have? Like, I'll drink after someone else.
Well, like, I feel like the straw is completely unnecessary because I don't feel like. When was the straw invented? The plastic drinking straw. Because I feel
fast food probably.
I feel like we have lived without it longer than we have lived with it. So that's another reason why I'm anti it. We certainly don't need it.
Yeah, but everybody eats in their car, except for you. But the rest of us.
I will drink a coffee without a lid on it and without a straw in my car. I drink coffee in my car.
But the rest of it, we have like some
older
sort of,
than I thought. 1937.
We got a Whopper on our lap. We're driving. We're trying to eat and drink.
Yeah,
we need the straw because we can't have the liquid would spill out of the top. Anyway, but I agree. At a restaurant, don't need a straw.
But I also now here's a different take. I'm also anti-metal straws.
Yes.
They're nerd.
I hate metal straws.
Yeah, when my wife pulls out, she has this
or
little...
Or silicone floppy.
The floppy silicone straw. I hate that. But my wife does something that is just embarrassing. She pulls out this little velour bag.
The satchel.
Yeah, the satchel, and she opens it, and then she pulls out her straws, and I'm like, oh, look. Little fucking nerd brought her 12-sided dice to the fucking Pizza Hut, so now she's going to pull out her little straws and her little knickknacks.
I'm not that
just
extreme.
Drink out of the cup. Just drink out of the cup.
Oh, man, I got a straw story for you. I totally forgot that, to talk about
that. That sounds
this.
Like Monica Lewinsky or something. Like, I don't know where you're going with this. Like, what are you doing? Man, I got a straw for you. I put one in my wife's butt.
So I'm going to text you a picture so you can put it up on Twitch. Because,
are we allowed to put it up?
You got
to
see this. Okay, so last night, so today was the day that all the kids had to bring in their Valentine's Day boxes. In elementary school.
Why? It's Monday.
Well, because they wanted everybody to bring in early so that on Monday they have it, and then that way the people forgot will bring in on Monday. It's like, you know, they know that parents are going to be forgetful, so they okay. want to do it early, you know, because I wouldn't even known unless my wife.
Oh, my God.
Like they say in the little packet you take home, they're like, we're going to hand out all Valentine's Day cards on Monday or whatever. Bring a box so your child can have like the cards deposited in the box, but also bring a card for everybody in the class so that you know, yeah. they do that shit. So anyway, Crystal, she's compensating for something. Like she wants to go above and beyond with everything with these kids. So like she makes this ornate Valentine's Day
box.
She's
like a Pinterest mom.
And yeah, but she also waits the last minute and stuff. So she has grandiose plans.
This is ridiculous, dude. This is for children?
I mean, this is amazing. No. I'm seeing if I can get this.
So speaking of Pinterest, she goes online and sees like cute ideas for kids' Valentine's. Right. And then she finds it and prints it out and does this, right? So I get home and she's cooking dinner. She's like, can you slit the nostril in 50 of these cards so I can put the pixie stick, you know, the whole thing? And then I look
she
at it.
She did it?
I look at it and I'm like, it kind of looks like this guy's snorting cocaine.
100% looks like he's snorting cocaine.
And it's like, and it's a pixie stick. So yeah. It kind of looks like we're... sending her sons.
Why would she do
Valentine.
This one?
Because she's like, this is on Pinterest. I got the idea. It's cute. No, it's a pixie stick. No one's gonna think that. These are fucking elementary school. I'm like, well, that's the first thing
the
I thought.
The teachers are definitely gonna think that.
That's what I told
her. The parents
her.
Are definitely
and,
gonna think that.
And she's like, no, this is a cute thing. It's like, and then it's like, I pick you and the candies.
Like
and
they're
the,
picking their nose. And the, yeah. That's her. Oh my God.
And the,
no.
the candies and those. But I'm like, oh, yeah, but man,
it's a powdered candy in their nose.
It's powdered a straw.
Oh my God.
It's when the guy's got a mustache. He looks like a cokehead.
Yes, he does.
It's cokehead. It looks like Mike B.
I'm gonna.
How dare you?
If you put a nose ring, it'd be Mike B. snorting coke.
I'm gonna have to add this. I'm gonna have to add this later. I can't open it right now.
Okay. This is nuts.
I'll add it later to the video so you can see exactly what we're talking about. It says Valentine, I pick you, your friend, and it is a 1970s cool dude with a line of blow right up his nose. That's great.
So that and you agree like this.
That's
looks
the first
like
thing I thought.
Someone.
I thought it was a joke. I didn't think she actually printed it out. I thought she just came across these.
No.
You can't send your kids to school with that?
Yeah, you
did you
can.
Do it already?
It's no. Yeah.
It's fine.
Well, here's what I do.
Maisie like, gave
dudes,
all of her kids trash.
CPS is getting called on you guys.
Well, we just gave all fun dip. Like, we just went all trash candy. And then for kids that can't have candy, we have keychains. Because kids love keychains. Give them trash.
So, I didn't argue
that
much.
Oh, they want you to hold the picture up to the camera on Twitch.
Yeah, you can do it from your phone probably.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, I'll put it up later, guys. Sorry.
So, okay, here's the picture. Hold on.
My God.
Let me get it.
It's a...
That's going to be problematic, dude.
It's a cool dude. Nah, I think it's like a booger thing. It's like they're going to go boogers, not blow. Guaranteed.
So, I don't think...
Well, the kids will.
Teacher's not going to say anything.
Parents will.
Nah.
Maybe not Castleberry parents.
Parents don't care. All parents don't care.
Yeah, but this is fucking awesome.
Yeah, most parents do not care.
Most parents won't even look through the kids' Valentine's Day box, but...
do not care.
Anyway, I sat there, like... And so my whole thing, I make the joke, and then it's starting to bother my wife because she's the one that's the thing, too. I didn't know that this was going on. I didn't read the packet of, like, this is what, you know, I would have just, If it was, I would have just sent them to school. I would have no idea. They will know nothing because they like me.
Do you feel like sort of I feel like with Andrea and Crystal, because I see both of them doing this. The bond that they have is obviously different with the kids. And you said you were kind of nailing it when you were saying they're compensating for something. It's almost like the amount of pressures that are on modern day moms to like do above and beyond, like do like not just do sufficient. You got to almost do extraordinary to even be like considered like you're doing a good job, which I think is insane.
Well, you have to compete against the other moms.
You do.
And so who's the best mom?
Well, she's going to look like party mom now, let me tell you.
Well, the Pinterest stuff, though, it's out of control because everything is like, it used to be like a Valentine for me was just like a piece of paper. I had to tear them myself and I didn't do a good job and I wrote shitty on them and it was just like a nice tip of the hat to say like, hey, you're my friend. It wasn't candy. It wasn't a box. It wasn't a bag. There was no keychain. There was no fun to it. Moms weren't doing anything other than taking me to roses.
It's just one more thing for parents to have to buy.
Yeah.
And like, what if these kids are poor? They can't come up with all these goddamn Valentines.
No, no. Also, you didn't have to buy one for everybody.
No, it's your friends.
So the fat nerds got nothing.
Yeah. they don't need candy.
You sat there, you're like, oh, fat nerd, you're getting nothing. you're sad.
Do we have Ross on news?
We do.
Okay,
are we pushing that?
Because we're taking
a break.
Do you want to message him and just let him know we're running a little bit late, and then we'll jump into the music. This is cool. We got really unique music that came across my desk yesterday morning. Actually, this came in like 11th hour. The band, the Alkaline Trio, right?
Yep.
We know that band. We also know that Matt Skiba went and he's with Blink 182 now?
Yes.
He kind of is filling in, I guess, permanently there. Well, then, you know, the other guy from Alkaline Trio is Dan. Dan Andriano? Andriano? If I'm saying that correctly. His band is Dan Andriano and the Bygones. The name of the song is Dear Darkness. That's the same name as the album. It's really, really good, man. If you like Alkaline Trio, this is kind of what you were missing, that like gritty, like almost like Americana version of what they used to do. I've always liked Dan better than Matt in this band.
Yeah.
Enjoy this, and we'll be right back. Freestyle, buddy. We haven't done that in a minute.
Tom Bryan. Cocaine Man sees Valentine's Day. Cards are hard.
Cards are hard, Tom Bryan.
Welcome back to Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. Let's do it.
All right, buddy.
Ross's Piece of Shit News.
Ross's News brought to you by Johnny's. Johnny's Other Side. Johnny's Filling Station. Still the home of $3 craft beers, those delicious tater tots. They still have the Real Man Burger on the menu, one of our original sponsors.
It's good, man. I had a buddy hit me up. He was looking for a place to watch. He was looking for a place to watch football, and I suggested Johnny's, and he saddled up there with a burger. They got the TVs. He went inside because it was raining. He was on his motorcycle, and he got a hamburger and was able to watch some playoff football.
Yep.
So Johnny's and Johnny's Other Side.
How you doing, Ross?
Do not sleep on the beet burger. The beet burger at Johnny's is the shit. He's got the beet burger and the beet salad is awesome. Johnny's got some weird hookup with beets. I don't know where.
All beets, everything.
The beet burger, before it was even popular, he had this on the menu. And then Ross would tell me to try it. And it is very, very good. It also, like, kind of, I think it tricks you because it sort of looks like, you know, it's the color of meat. It's not like some weirdo color.
But you also...
Color of meat.
You'll wake up the next day and think you're dying of some sort of ass cancer, right?
Yes.
That's part of the fun.
It is, especially you're drinking.
Because the relief that you remember, the beaver, and then it's like, it's a wave of endorphins.
And then you yell, you're honey, it's not ass cancer. They love that.
So, Ross, how you been?
Pretty good.
Dude, the hair, we've gotten more comments about how luxurious your hair is. You're still keeping with a consistent, do you have a regimen that you used, or men or meant both, on your hair to make it so luxurious and great?
Yeah. It's a thing. You can probably Google the system if you want the whole breakdown. It's called the Head and Shoulder System. like 2 and 3 times a week. Yeah, Head and Shoulders.
Love it.
Shampoo and conditioner.
Knees and toes. I love it.
What do you got first, Ross?
We jumping right in. I thought we were going to talk about your kid's cocaine problem.
No, okay. Well, okay. So I forget that some of us on the show, some of us on Twitch. So I showed you, Ross, this is the Valentine's Day card that my wife picked out, and she made me cut the nose holes and stick the pixie sticks through like 50 of these things to give out to Max and Tommy and, you know, whatever.
50? My God. We only had to do 15.
But when I made the joke, and then she's like, people think that? And then she's like, well, maybe we can go to Target and get some new. And then I was like, nah, people won't think that.
This is not cocaine. Just write this is not cocaine.
It's literally called Booger Sugar.
I immediately.
Yeah, but this is actual Booger Sugar, not cocaine.
I immediately started saying, no, you know what? I was, you know, no one's. That's not going to come to anybody's mind because I don't want to have to go do that. I just cut 50 nose holes in the goddamn cocaine one. Yeah.
And so you guys did all of their Valentines for them?
No, yeah, they don't want to do nothing. They don't care. No one cares.
Wait a minute. You know, I didn't ask this question because
they don't care.
Maisie already did hers too. Did they fill them out themselves?
I don't think so. It's just the cocaine nose.
No. You got to write the name. You write.
Oh my God.
You write.
No, they didn't write nothing.
You write 2, and then let's say there's one kid in her class. His name is Max. Another Max. She wrote 2 Max.
From Maisie.
You flip it over. Yeah. No, she didn't write from. Oh. She just wrote Maisie.
Oh, okay.
You know, like. That's
no,
it.
My sons don't know anybody's name.
I ask them, like, who's your, they're like, the guy, what's their name?
I got a guy. Yeah.
And that's super important so you don't, like, accidentally give B mine to the wrong kid or some shit like that. You know, you got to hand select each Valentine for each kid as they go.
Okay, well, Ross, they're all the Ross same nailed now. It because that's exact, dude, you're.
They're trying to get rid of that. They don't want one kid feeling like he's left out or some more special.
There's a specific moment in time that Ross will remember when we were driving to see an Orlando City match when I vowed in the back of, I believe, his van that I would never, I would never do all of the dumb stereotypical things and that he didn't know anything and you didn't know anything and I was going to do it a different way. And I was wrong and he was right. Ross was 1,000% right.
That was almost the day the show died.
American Pie. Just the fact that Ross said you have to hand select each Valentine for each kid. That's exactly what Maisie did. So she was like, well, Max, he likes this, so I wrote this, and he doesn't like candy, so I'm giving him a dinosaur keychain. Boom. And then each one was like a process like that.
Well, Maisie's an overachiever. I've been telling her she's going to be a CEO.
She's like her mom.
My sons, they're like me. They do the least amount possible. They're lazy.
Yeah, but they're fun.
They don't know anybody's name. They don't know. They don't care. Like, they don't even care. If we sent them with nothing, they'd be like, all right. They just don't. I'm mad about it. Anyway.
See, what you label overachieving is actually called empathy, Tom. It's the ability to put yourselves in others' shoes and experience their lives.
Well, I made my sons, and they're like me. I curse them, Ross. I don't know what to do.
Exactly.
They're like me, and it drives me crazy because then I'm like, oh, no, now I know what other people feel like. And then I'm like, no wonder. It's my curse. It's their curse. We're all cursed. Anyway.
All right. Now, on second glance, of course, on first glance at these cards, of course, it looks like you're promoting cocaine use among children. That it looks like the cards were designed by Stitches. Like, But second glance, I didn't realize in the fucking Coke shades, by the way, that are on these cards,
right.
It is written the words, I pick you. What they're really doing is promoting, like, nose picking.
Yeah,
promoting nose picking and or candy snorting. Either way, like, it's a whole nasal thing that this card has going on that is completely inappropriate.
Didn't we learn anything from Navaj a couple of weeks ago? That just to avoid all the nasal stuff altogether.
Also, like, don't, like, pixie sticks, the worst candy, right? Like, no one wants that shit.
I love them. No, that's fine. I mean, it's just candy. All it is it's that Sour Patch, citric acid, and then just like.
Yeah, it's like powdered sugar. Yeah, and it just seems like some chocolate. It's all always better. Anyway.
Well, it's more expensive, though.
Well, the money, I mean, who knows how much this cost? I mean,
well,
my
this
time,
was just time.
I would have thrown money at it, no problem.
That's
I don't want
to
do any of this. Anyway.
We bought the store-bought ones, man. I mean, you and your wife go above and beyond because we just bought this straight up. I just said, what do you got, Paw Patrol? You just get the Paw Patrol.
Bro, it's not me. Like, I don't, I had to cut the nose holes, but that was because she ran out of time.
You look like a nose hole guy. Well,
anyway, Ross, what do we got for first story?
You, I think, Tom, maybe you were like candy pampered. I can remember being a kid and I would go to my grandma's house and pretend I had hiccups because her cure for hiccups was a spoonful of sugar.
That's pretty awesome. I used to sugar my Cheerios so much that, and then I would shake it so the sugar would fall off the top of the dry Cheerios. You'll follow me with this. And then all the sugar would get in the milk and go to the bottom. And then I'd eat my Cheerios, but lightly. I'd eat them lightly. And then I'd scrape the sugar off the bottom in the milk and eat that. And I thought that that was the greatest food created was sugar in milk.
Sludge.
Yes, the sludge. It's delicious. And the granules, you can squish them around on your tongue and teeth. Oh, my God.
Maybe my mom always had cookies and candies out, and like we had a snack cabinet.
We have a snack cabinet, and but there's a bunch of nerd garbage in it that Andrea buys.
Oh, my mom was all candy cookies. But so then my friends loved it. They were like, "Oh my God, this is insane!" Because they didn't have that, and I was like, So I've never been into sweets. Maybe it's because it was always available, and so I was like one of those things. I don't know.
Oh, man, I don't know how many times I heard the words, get the fuck out of the kitchen when I was a kid. Like, we were not allowed in there. Like, we ate what was on the table at dinner time. And that was fucking it, dude.
Well, that's what you're supposed to do. I could just do whatever I want. There was no rule.
Boundaries.
I've never had a rule.
Now, how do you feel about this? We have implemented something new around the Dennis household. Sorry, Ross. We'll get the news. But this is something that I'd like to get your opinion on. Because Andrea thinks it's okay, I think it's okay. The only person that really truly hates it is Maisie. So when we sit down to eat dinner, if we finish our dinner, if you finish your dinner and you're still hungry, you can either have more dinner or you can wait and you can have like a little snick snack, like maybe even some ice cream or something. But if you don't finish your dinner, or if you don't even try to eat your dinner, ice cream's completely off the table. Because if you're going to eat anything, you should probably eat your vegetables and your proteins and stuff like that. So lately, I'll finish my dinner. Maisie won't even try her dinner. And then I'll just go get ice cream and I'll just eat it in front of her. And it drives her insane. But I say, look, the rule is that, you can be here with me if you eat your dinner. I'm not forcing you to eat your dinner. If you're not hungry, don't eat. I get it. But if you eat all your dinner, you may have ice cream. I don't wait until later to eat it. And Andrea has lately said, why don't you wait until she goes to bed before you do that? It's kind of like you're doing it in her face.
But I like that. It'll show her, look what I get.
Am I doing it wrong? I would like to ask the people that I do trust both of you. I do think that you guys know what you're doing, especially Ross. I know he knows his way around some kiddos. Well,
as Ross.
Ross, so what should I wait, or am I okay doing what I'm doing?
See, I can't even really answer this question rightfully, because on any given night, I might cook four different dinners just to get people to fucking eat.
Okay.
No, like,
I will cook whatever. I cook like a dinner for me and the wife that we're going to eat. Usually one kid's pretty good, pretty down for whatever it is. He'll eat whatever it is. And then or sometimes he wants something else. And then one kid needs a whole different thing every fucking night. So
yeah.
I just cook a bunch
of
shit.
Isn't he old enough to cook now, though? I'm surprised at you, Ross.
They go in there. They know, it's the little guy that has the most issue. He's picky. And so if dinner rolls by and he doesn't like it, he's like, fuck it. After you clean up, I'll make some eggs or something.
Gotcha. Yeah.
But then
yeah.
Only,
yeah.
I like that.
That's what I would do.
Yeah. Eggs, listen,
if you can make eggs, you can live life. Eggs are important.
Yeah.
We all grow up. You get a job. We're fucking. Same shit. Anyway, what do we got, Ross?
All right, and we're officially starting news, so I'll remind you, we are in the Tom and Dan Go to War t-shirt giveaway. If Russia goes to war with the Ukraine during the piece of shit news, and you send a time-stamped email to Tom at tomanddan.com with the subject line, Team Putin, you will win a Tom and Dan t-shirt.
There you go.
Are they in war right now?
Breaking news. All American citizens to leave the Ukraine immediately. Biden said, we will not send troops to rescue Americans if Moscow invades Ukraine.
Yeah.
And that's coming from the guy who said we would get you out of Afghanistan under any circumstances and then left a bunch of people.
Right.
So I'm pretty sure this means he will attack you personally in Ukraine himself.
That's a funny joke.
Yeah, didn't they try to cut off their gas pipeline?
They're saying that they will if it continues to happen. I have been truthfully, I've been avoiding all of this. Like, I've been head in the sand because I just I've been all up in the VR wankers.
Also, I have no idea about geopolitics. Can't even say it. But it's like, all right, you're gonna
second try.
You're gonna cut off the gas pipeline. I'm pretty sure Russians and like the people in charge and Putin and like they thought that might happen, and that's not gonna stop them, right? Like they were not gonna get this far and be like, oh shit, they cut off our gas and bring them back. Like they probably
like they know pipelines and sanctions and all of that are happening.
Yeah, they probably when they were planning this thing. Said, hey, this they'll probably sanction us here, cut the gas off here. We'll figure that. You know what I'm saying? It's like none of this small shit was going to stop them from doing this. I'm just going out there and venturing a guess, right? Like, so this is all just bullshit to say, look, we did something, but they knew they were going to do it the whole time.
That's
right?
What it sounds like, yeah.
Yeah, they're not saying we're going to dismantle this pipeline and plant trees along the route or anything. So, like, the pipeline's still going to be there. You turn it off. Guess what? You can turn it back on again.
Yeah. They're just waiting until no one's paying attention. They turn it back on. They're paying us. So what does this mean once they, can they, all right, let's say Russia takes over the Ukraine, right? Mm-hmm. And then they now say this is ours and is part of Russia. When does the rest of the world recognize that and be like, well, they're no longer Ukraine. Take that off the globe. Like, get new globes. you know what I'm saying? Like, do they say, like, all right, I guess it's because
I don't know
happened before.
It absolutely has happened before. But, yeah, I don't know. I don't know when you do that, because I would imagine diplomatically there'd be more going on and there'll be sanctions and they'll be handling that. I mean, Ukraine is not officially a part of NATO.
Like you guys remember when Czechoslovakia was a country, and now it's Czech Republic and Slovakia, right?
Yugoslavia.
It's like they split it. So, and they had to change all the globes and the maps to account for that. So, I'm just wondering when they change the maps. Like, when do they say, all right, it's too far
gone.
That's
a good question.
It's never going back.
Even in, like, textbooks and stuff,
too.
It
actually is a delineation. It is the next time the Google Maps car rolls through that area.
Yeah, you know what's funny, Ross, is I was on, like, VR yesterday using the Wander app where you can go anywhere in the world. And I was standing in the middle of Times Square, and it's funny to see the places that they can get to all the time and how often they're updated, and the places you can't get to all the time, how they're old as hell. Like, I'm standing in, like, Bora Bora, it's 2016, but if you're in Times Square, it's 2022. About how often that car is running through, you know? Like, it's pretty neat. Oh, by the way, if you go to my old place of business using the Wander app and you have VR and you go to my old place of business that I worked for many, many years, you will see somebody I very much dislike walking out of that building.
All right.
just a fun, it's a fun little game people can play with their VR headsets.
All right, Ross, what's next?
Dude, that fucking car rolls by our street all the fucking time. And I swear to God, we've lived here 20 years. And of that time, like a cumulative, like, 3 weeks of time, we've had three different cars in the yard, like, dead for a little bit. And the goddamn thing always puts up a picture with the dead car in the yard.
I did it again yesterday using that Google camera thing and using the Wander app on the VR. I wanted to say, I wanted to, like, try and hack my brain a little bit because it's so gross outside lately. I'm like, I'm going to go to the Bahamas. So I go to the Bahamas in the Wander app. I land in the water. I turn to my right. Immediately, there's a topless lady standing there. They had it blurred out, but she was topless 100%. I'm like, all right, this is pretty cool. I had no idea that was a thing that Google had to do. They got to go around and blur faces and boobs.
That's hilarious.
It is awesome.
Ross.
VR is awesome. I love it.
The broken car in the yard, because we had this issue, too, where my mother-in-law had my sister-in-law's old broken car that we bought her when she turned 16.
Oh, that was a hunk of junk.
Yeah, it was a Hyundai, purple Hyundai.
Purple Hyundai Elantra.
And it finally
That's the Elantra.
It finally died, and it just sat in our front yard for a while, right?
It's funny how cars do that. They don't wander off.
And then, and I always wondered, like, what are we waiting for? Because then finally, some guy came by and paid her, like, $300 cash to go get it because it's worth, like, $450 a junk or whatever.
Right.
Or, like, and especially used cars now, you think they at least, like, are worth around there. But just for scrap metal, they're worth $400. So a company will come pick it up for free for like $250 or whatever. It's cash in your pocket.
I like that billboard where it has the lady with the sailor's outfit on. It's like, donate your boat to children.
Yeah, boat angel.
So is it the broken car? Is it that you may think you're going to fix it and get it running someday? Because there is a service that will come pick it up for free. I always wonder, like, what are they waiting for something, or are they waiting for it's to a, make the call?
I think it's a wait on it dream.
Yeah. We had this cute little BMW 318i that we had for years, and we moved down here, and it kind of went. And we parked it, and we just couldn't get the money together to fix it. And then finally frogs were living in the doors.
the frog doors.
Dude, I had a 318 Ti, the hatchback version of that. That was a fun-ass little car. Those little
my favorite car for no other reason that all four window controls were in the center console. So, like, whether or not, whether my, me or my wife was driving, I could be in control of the windows.
Yeah, the 318, don't sleep on that. That's a fun little ride. What else you got?
But that thing I sold on eBay Motors, and I got a good fucking bit of money, frogs in the doors and all. Like, I put pictures of the frogs in the doors on fucking eBay, and somebody still bought it. And then the other one, this should have been a clue. This guy, my wife was, like, going to church at the time, and this guy was renting in a house from the pastor, and the pastor was like, hey, you got to get that fucking car out of there, or I'm going to have it towed. And so we were like... He was like giving him like, oh, I just need a week or two to get my fucking feet back together. And so like we were like, yeah, park it in our yard for a while. And it was this fucking monstrosity of a fucking rice burner that this guy had painted with like yellow house paint. And then that shit was on Google for a million goddamn years in our yard, basically. And then I think right now it's a picture of my kid's car when he parked it. He needed tires and he parked it for like a minute.
And Google comes out, there it is. Still there.
They drive by really, really fast. You reminded
me. Oh, and I'm probably, you guys, we could be giving away way a lot of t-shirts. I haven't checked on the war clock yet.
Okay.
But, we are Russia heavy at the top of news today. In news that should probably scare you if you think about it, French President Emmanuel Macron went to Russia and he was meeting with Putin and they said, hey, you can meet with Putin either way, but if you want to shake his hand and like sit next to him and have a coffee and shit, you got to take a PCR test. And Macron declined. So they did this thing where they sat him at a table that was 4 meters long. That's like 12-ish feet, Tom. Like, so this 12-foot long marble-ass table. So they meet like, and they like, instead of a handshake, they like stand across from the room from each other and like, hey, what's up? And so... there, Macron, like his team released, they said the protocol for the test didn't fit his health protocol. But somebody went off the record and leaked that they said that the real reason he didn't take the test was because he didn't want the Russians having his DNA.
I didn't. That's not what I would have thought. Okay, little Danny, I'm not a diplomat.
I mean, can you blame him?
But call me little Danny diplomat. I'm going over for the U.S. to broker the talks, right? And they go, hey, you got to have a PCR test. And I look him right in the eyes and I say, you're going to kill me. You're going to put poison in my nose, aren't you? I know how you Russians do. You do the poison up the nose thing. Let's not do that. Is there any other way you can test me? Right? You just hit him with the knowledge. Like, I know how you guys do things. You guys put, you next thing you know, I got an isotope up my nose. And I'm, right? Isn't that what they do, Ross? Yeah. They put isotopes into people.
Polonium! No fucking polonium! You're right in the brain, dude!
I'm not.
A fucking microscopic speck of it will cause a fucking... cancer the size of a goddamn grapefruit anywhere you put it, dude.
100%. I wouldn't even go there. I remember when Mark Marrow said, I'm taking my tour to Russia. I'm like, why the hell are you going there? They're going to put a fucking isotope in you.
Also, it's like, I'm pretty sure everybody feels this way about Russia. Like, they're not telling anybody shit that they're doing, and they have unlimited money to do whatever experiments they want and to do whatever genetic cloning you know what I'm saying? Like, other countries follow. I'm sure United States does some secret shit as well. Yeah. Of course we do, but I think other countries are held up to a higher standard where we're not testing on humans. We're not doing like cloning humans and other shit that like is frowned upon globally. But Russia's doing all that shit, right?
They're doing
what like the goddamn Nazis did. It was like experiment on humans and shit. Like, so I wouldn't put it past them that they have the ability, because we have the science to clone human beings, and then that Russian president, like, you're not cloning me or getting my DNA, right? Because they'll do it. No,
French.
Oh, sorry.
I wouldn't worry about them cloning me. I just, like, I would worry about them putting something up me and getting me good.
Yeah. I mean,
right, we'll talk about the Russian trustworthiness in the next story. But, Dan, I will remind you, they killed that guy in England. They put fucking radioactive isotope in his tea and killed his ass. And then got away scot-free. And then two people who were picking trash found the container that they brought the radioactive isotope over in, and it killed those motherfuckers too.
Yeah.
That
could have been two of the side chicks picking up the Tom and Dan Road. Side chicks are out there picking up trash. Next thing you know, they found the Russian isotope container and they're dead.
That's true.
That whole shit is bonkers. Like, and you touch it and you're dead. There's no, like, cure or there's no catching it early. It's just dead.
Like, I hear about those type of stories and I think about Putin or the guy that got killed or and I think about all of it. I'm like, is this how you want to live your life? This sounds really stressful and crazy. Don't you just want to, like, go camping a little bit, have some kids, take them to school, make a grilled cheese sandwich, live a little bit, smoke some weed?
Although it is interesting.
Why you got to do all this crazy shit?
That we have, like, perceived global supervillains still. And Putin's one of them.
Well, he looks like one.
And like
he fell asleep at the damn Olympics, too, sitting there in his black coat.
Olympics born.
Yeah. He could wear something different. You know, he could wear one of those poofy jackets from Old Navy, maybe soften himself up a little bit.
So at least we get the entertainment of a global supervillain, I guess.
I don't find it entertaining.
It's a horrible bummer.
It's a horrible bummer thinking that people are going to get injured or any military personnel are going to get hurt or killed. You know, that shit bums me out.
But it is like, oh, shit, they're doing it. Look what they're doing, this guy. Anyway.
What else you got, Ross?
Okay, so in the midst of an Olympics where there's accusations of, you know, if not outright cheating on the part of the host company, country, like at least strident attempts to influence maybe the outcomes of things through ways they can influence. A report was just submitted to the World Anti-Doping Agency by this doctor, and he does a pretty elaborate job of documenting the fact that in 2010 Winter Olympics, the Russians had kind of a shitty Winter Olympics. They didn't do what they wanted to. Yeah. And they know 2014 they're hosting in Sochi, right? So they come up with this. They everybody doped. Everybody on the Russian team doped. It's a fact now. Yeah. They're banned from competing. They were banned from competing for 4 years. It was reduced to like 2 years. After this report, there's calls now for them to the whole team, the whole Olympics of Russia to just be eliminated from the Olympics because the system they had, they doped, right? Then they got two guys on the inside at the testing facility. And so you'd have to go through security to get in. You couldn't really. It's a lot of guys. A lot of ladies. You couldn't put enough piss on your person to smuggle it in. So they came up what is being described as a mouse hole. They drilled a hole through the wall from a nearby non-secure area. And it was like during the day it would be covered. When this guy on the inside would be around by himself, he'd peel off the cover. Somebody would pass him like it was so that they would dope. They'd take a break, piss clean, freeze it, and then they'd thaw it out for the testing. So one of their guys would get tested, they'd go thaw some of his clean piss out from the freezer, pass it through the mouse hole, and then so they also had like the little tubes of piss had a security system on it too. They'd have to pick those, and they've gone back now and examined.
Wow.
They show like scratch marks of like lock picks to get into like the little tiny piss locks. So unfrozen piss through the mouse hole, lock pick the piss test tube, swap the first of all, empty, clean the test tube, put in the clean piss, and then relock in a secure manner, and then put back to be tested. That was the fucking system they came up with, and then it did.
Listen, I do kind of like doing this thing legit.
Long way to go.
Was not an option. They're like, how about we stop them? No. Like, I think we can do the mouse hole.
Yeah, let's try mouse hole first. Yeah. I know you want to go legit, but let's just try the mouse hole. Just do me, humor me. Just humor me.
What about vitamins? We try improved diet. Maybe we train a little harder, a little bit longer.
I know what you're saying, Ross, but I feel good about this mouse hole thing, man.
And and they know that doping
Ross
will give them
the
best
chance. Ross is just shaking his head. He's like, nah, what are you doing? Why are you doing this?
So they just won't stop cheating. They can't stop, won't stop.
Miley Cyrus.
And whatever. And so they're, you think they'll ever be a, I mean, I guess they're talking about it now where they'll eliminate Russia from even competing at all?
Yeah, that's what they're saying.
They did. They had him out for 4 years. They knocked it down to 2 years and they're back in. I think and it was limited. But yeah, right now they're calling for like just get Russia the fuck out of the Olympics.
Yeah. You know what sucks, too, is that when I see them, you know, they'll show pictures of them like all skating together or all like holding their, you know, the because they can compete right now. But under the title of Russian.
Yeah, yeah. Federation. Different. Yeah, they can't. Yeah, it's like have the Russian flag.
Yeah, it's like the Russian Federation or something like mm-hmm. So they can't really compete for Russia, but they can still compete. But when I see these kids, and that's what they are, they're kids, and they're like skating or holding their flag and stuff yeah, like yeah. that. I look at them and I go, you don't look like you would pass piss through a mouse hole. Like when I look at they don't yeah, look. Yeah. They're smiling. They're all like, they look like.
We're just young human athletes. Yeah, they just so happen to be born in Russia. And right. then their fucking politics sucks and their country is doing all the shit.
So I would think if you were able to sit down and talk to them, they'd be like, yeah, we didn't want to be like, we don't want to compete like this. We want to compete like everybody else.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But we were born on the villain side of things. Just like that movie Descendants from Disney. Just like that.
What's the next one, Ross?
All right, and we're going to stay a little bit into politics. There's a new book out. It's about Trump, and a couple of things about Trump that have been released from this book. This is the author. This lady Maggie Haberman. She wrote this book, and she says she can't verify whether or not this is an actual fact. But basically, she has firsthand accounts that Trump says this a lot. And that is the fact that what he says a lot to people is that the only world leader he stays in touch with is Kim Jong Il or Un, whichever one's still alive. The only world leader he stays in touch with is the leader of North Korea.
Kim Jong Un. I think it's Un. Yeah, I think it's Un.
Was it through like email or something? I
don't think he does email. I don't think Donald Trump does email. Yeah. I think he's a paper guy.
He's talking to him.
Here's what she says about it. Here's what she says. She says, what he says and what's actually happening are not always in concert, but he has been telling people that he has maintained some kind of a correspondence or discussion with Kim Jong-un.
Are you allowed to just talk to like a dictator?
I think I could. If I could tweet Kim Jong-un and he replied to me, right? That'd be cool.
Well, what I'm saying is, like, can you just call anybody and talk to anybody in the world that you want?
You're an American, Tom. Totally, you can do that.
but the even countries
the rules
that we have
are different when you're president, Tom, and that's true. And it's a great question. And it might be a little bit more lenient now that he's not the acting president. But when he was president, everything he did and said was subject to being on the record, which means that he had a bunch of correspondence. 15 boxes of papers that he was supposed to have turned over when he left the White House, but instead he took to Florida with him. He just turned them over to the National Archives, as he lawfully should have when he left the White House. And another thing from the book is that
I know what you're going to say. Is this the toilet?
It's a similar problem that we've always had at the T&D studios. White House staff apparently reported that they would find wads of clumped up wet printed paper, either notes or some emails. Other piece of paper that they believe he had thrown down the toilet.
Here's what I okay, this I is like not that. Political. I like it that. Too. This is what I created in my dumb Daniel brain. Okay, so this is why I like this. So Ross, follow me here. This is not political. This is just Trump the man. He's standing over the toilet. His pants are all the way down to the floor, right? Belt and everything. Clang. Underwear all the way down the floor. He's peeing one of those long dad pisses.
His pants are so fucking big, they're like 4 foot circles around his ankles
they're
at
big.
The floor.
And he's reading these emails as he's peeing. Oh, and he's just balling them and putting them in the toilet and peeing on top of them. That's right.
You'll never find him here.
No, I don't think he's hiding here. He's just reading and peeing, reading and peeing. He's just throwing like garbage. And then he just flushes and walks out. And oh, yeah, there it is.
He's like, yeah, don't give a shit.
I saw reading and peeing in Athens. They were fucking awesome. Now, do you think Do you think he does that thing where like people use their pointer finger to like speed read? Does he do that with his stream of piss, Dan?
I can't.
Sometimes I think that he's trolling a little bit, you know, where he's like, someone asks him like, "Do you keep up with any world leaders?" And Kim Jong Un just he says that to media just to fuck with them because they'll report it, and then he's like, "Look how
stupid
they are." And
then it just makes people mad.
And then but he's just trolling.
Everything's a troll now, man.
There's
including my entire body.
And it's almost where you could just say shit at a certain point. It's like Antonio Brown or anybody that's making news. It's the same reason they interviewed us about the Bob Saget thing. And it still is on U.S. or what is it?
We hit Good Morning America this morning and right before we got
Today's
on
the show.
Our Today Show. And Good Morning America this morning. We hit two of those. And the last one, right before we went on the show, we were on E! Entertainment Television again.
Yeah, so they had us on the Today Show talking about Bob Saget again, and then it's like, what do we have nothing to do with any of this?
There was no update.
Ross, Inside Edition.
Full time is media's bullshit.
This is how shitty and vulture-y Inside Edition is. They emailed me yesterday to say, hey, quick follow up. Bob didn't say anything about his head hurting or anything, did he? I mean, I almost wanted to be, come to think of it. Yeah, absolutely. It's all he talked about.
Yeah, it's all just filling time and shit. And then no one cares. Anyway.
What else you got, Ross?
Now, he didn't do that thing because the couch is a little bit short. He didn't do that hard sit down and bang his head in the studio, Dan, did he?
No, he wasn't in here. He called. We didn't even get him via Zoom. It was just a call in. You know? We know as much as his family knows, as much as the authorities know. I mean, they're saying this is the term that made it weird for me last night, not to talk about the Bob Saget thing, but my wife and I were discussing it. The family released that it's head trauma. Then I read an article that he was COVID positive, and then they used the term catastrophic head trauma. Catastrophic.
Yeah, because it killed him.
Yeah. And mysterious. Right. It's
weird.
Well, unfortunate to his family that there's a mysterious this is odd and also not very statistically likely. Like, we don't hear about it all the time. No. Like, people passing away from head trauma, mild head trauma that they didn't even like bother to tell anybody about. So it's like, so then,
but they're not even using the term mild. They're saying catastrophic. Well, people have known?
Right. Because
you don't use the term like for instance. Like, I think you guys would know if I were concussed or acting weird. I mean, you guys know when my anxiety's off. You know what I mean?
Like I said, this happened to my mother-in-law's friend where a wrench fell in her head, and then she had a brain bleed from a standard wrench, and then it just hit her the right way. So like, weird things like that happen.
I think it's gonna be a bathroom slip and fall at the end of the day, because that's where the odds are in my mind. It's gonna be a bathroom slip and fall, and then as a comic on the road, like, you just don't want to add another thing to your fucking itinerary. I'm sure however he did it, he banged his fucking head and he's like, I want to go to sleep and then get to fucking Miami or wherever the next stop is. I'm just going to sleep this off. And if I have time tomorrow, I'll stop by a minute clinic or whatever. But like, he just didn't want to go to the fucking emergency room in the middle of the night after a show and shit.
I could see that.
He just drove back from Jacksonville. Totally could see that. Know what I'm saying? So he probably, you know, he thought it wasn't that bad, you know. I mean,
also, by the way, this person that contacted you, what if like you did have audio of him saying, oh shit, I banged my head on a pull up bar just now, like, and you were just sitting on it and you didn't fucking.
Right.
Like, what the fuck do they think?
I don't think they think. I think
they just need to fill time.
Yeah, exactly. What do they think? Nothing.
They're not trying to find the truth. They're not getting the bottom of anything. It's just some guy that gets paid to fill time and he's trying to fill time so anything will work. Yeah. And if whatever
even
we said.
Even if it's wrong.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's the entertainment news. It's all fluffy nonsense.
Yeah, sucks.
Anyway.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of which, Billie Eilish, you guys.
Yeah, I'm a fan.
She fucking good. She's good, Dan. She did a concert recently. A fan in the crowd, appeared to be gasping.
I saw this.
Okay. Yeah, it's a viral video right now. She stops the concert. She goes, here's what she says. She says, quote, do you need an inhaler? Guys, give it some time. Don't crowd. We're taking care of our people. Hold on. I wait for people to be okay until I keep going. End quote. That's what she said. Okay.
Yes.
Video goes viral. A guy who's got bigger fucking fish to fry right now,
right.
Kanye West, chimes in and he says, hey, this is a shot at my boy Travis Scott. Like out of nowhere, he says, this is a shot at Travis Scott. I'm not having it. He's appearing with me at Coachella. And if Billie Eilish apologized, otherwise Kanye is not coming to Coachella. So Kanye,
fuck off.
Yeah. Kanye inserted himself where he did not need to, made up some shit that did not exist, and then huge fucking ultimatum to get an apology for something that didn't happen.
To be fair, even though I hate trying to be on Kanye's side, the media started running the headline that Billie Eilish threw shade at Travis Scott, which she never said his fucking name, but that was every goddamn headline because people were assuming that it was.
Again, media, what media does. Entertainment.
So then Kanye is just like, Billie Eilish, you better apologize. She doesn't give a fuck if you play Coachella. It's not her festival.
I like Billie Eilish. I like Kanye West for what they are. I don't know them, so I can't really like them because I don't interact with them daily. But yeah, if I were Billie Eilish, I would have to say,
did you see her response?
Kanye. Did she respond?
Yeah, she responded. She tweeted out, she's like, literally never said his name. So she's like, I was just taking care of fans at my show.
Yeah, of course, that's the reality. Yeah. But
also, he needs some help.
But it's kind of,
losing his fucking mind on Instagram right now, Dan. It is fucking fascinating.
He's back to begging him to come back.
I'll text you later.
He's trolling too. Like, he knows.
He's mentally ill.
He is mentally ill, but he's also smart. And you can't argue that he's not super smart.
And he knows how to manipulate the media. He does.
He was married to Kim Kardashian. He knows this shit.
He's divorcing a girl who was shot out of the dick of the best, arguably the best lawyer that ever existed in this country. He's divorcing her, and he's just talking crazy shit on Instagram. I got a deleted post I will send you, Dan. It's fucking amazing. It's this long rambling post about how I can't. Oh, so the court's gonna tell me when I can come visit my kids?
Right.
I
like that. There's no idea how it works.
My favorite Kanye lyric of all time is in this post where he's like, he says some shit about, she's gonna try to get me for stealing. All I did was take my Akira comic books.
Well, yeah.
And then he's so smart, he deletes it. Oh, no, nobody screen capped that Kanye West in the fucking 12 hours it was up or whatever. Right. It's gone. Crazy, fucking man. Idiot.
Love it.
Well, he is bipolar, but I do believe that he's just fucking with the media. And, like, I think he knows how it works, and he knows whatever thing he says is going to be a huge story nationwide, and that's a lot of power.
What's the end game here, though? Coachella is a fucking big payday, and I'm pretty sure he needs money right now. He's got to need money. He's divorcing Kim fucking Kardashian again. And, so he threatens, I'm going to lose that payday unless she apologizes. What are you going to do when she doesn't? Because she's not going to. Are you going to perform and just be a lying asshole? Or are you going to not and be a fucking idiot?
I don't think.
Interesting.
He'll be an asshole. He's a narcissist.
Maybe there's a plan. So, but it's the same thing with Antonio Brown. You're like, why did you throw away such a payday in the NFL to go do this shit? And it's like, whether or not there's any sort of thought out plan, I think it's a lot of it is like, hey, I'm getting attention. We'll just go where it takes me. We'll do this. Like Kanye West, he doesn't need the Coachella money, but also he can go back at his word and be like, I'll play it. You don't know.
Yeah. I mean, like, it doesn't matter. Yeah. I had a change of heart. You guys deserve the concert anyway.
Yeah, but he got a bunch of media attention. I don't even know if it's for that, because what does he need that for?
And
so,
then
Pete
Davidson came out and he made his relationship with Kim Kardashian official, what, like 2 days ago?
Oh, I didn't even see that.
Yeah, my wife told me. She's like, yeah, Pete confirmed it, and like they're together. Yeah. And then apparently all of Kanye's fans are like death threatening Pete like a mug. And yeah, so Ross, you're gonna get a really fun Kanye watch party. I mean, this is gonna go on for a while. If we'll be texting for a minute, because this
like
is
Russia
happening.
And Ukraine.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be crazier than that. The Russia and Ukraine thing's been around for forever.
You know how you get partial custody of your kids or even visitation rights with your kids? Not by making up rumors that their new stepdad has AIDS out of nowhere.
If you like a celebrity that you've never met, like, this is, well, the problem with all of this is there are so many dumb people that we can't control. It's just, we're in a sea of endless dumb people.
Yes.
And if you are a fan of some celebrity you don't even, never even met, so much that you're putting death threats out to his ex-wife's new boyfriend or whatever the fuck, you're dumb and wasting your life, right? Yeah. Like, what is this? Like, you don't even know these people. You're fucking putting death threats. Also, it's easier than ever to write a death threat. You used to have to find someone's address. Now I just put it on Twitter.
Yeah.
And it's
It'll get there.
And it's the dumb person's, like, you know, no one's actually serious about all this, but they'll put that. And then, and again, the media picks it up, and it's all this dumbass shit.
Yeah.
That no one... Dumb. Does anybody even care? Like, some people do care. Well, We're talking about it.
I'll watch it because it's the spectacle. But yeah. At the end of the day, if I tell you my real feelings on it, I'm sad. Because these people look like they're tortured sick
there's
people.
Kids involved.
Yeah, they're sick people, yeah. Like, fucking around with kids and shit. Yeah. You know, yeah.
But there's also an element of famous people that crave fame will do this shit to the end of time. It's yeah. the radio.
Stay relevant.
It's the radio show host thing.
It's almost like leaders of nations will do this shit until the end of time because it's never enough.
Like, I don't know Danny Bonaducci, but I imagine at the time when he was on radio and shit, he'd do whatever fucking thing they would keep him relevant and keep the media talking no matter what. If it made him look bad and it hurt his family, he didn't give a shit. All he wanted was the fame because that felt like something to him. And there's people that live like that where the fame means something more than even money or anything.
It means you're relevant. You know?
Yeah, and then that makes them feel good and they'll just keep doing that shit. And I think some of these celebrities are like that. Like, they just crave
the fame.
There's
that guy people have called the Orlando's Danny Bonaducci, Drunky the Bear. He used to be like that.
Yep, 100%. Riding a skateboard, chugging vodka, take
jump
steroids.
Anything on a fucking undersized scooter. Yeah.
Yeah. Did you know Tom started taking steroids?
What else we got, Ross?
That's probably a good idea. That'll pay off in the next.
He would.
He's not.
He wants to though.
I want to too. I'll tell you when I'm to start taking it. I'll tell you.
I think as I get older, I want to do more drugs. I got mushrooms lined up. I got acid lined up. I got it all. Yeah. I'm ready. Take me to the moon. What else you got, Ross?
I got like a Facebook ad where you can just buy testosterone through the mail now. I was thinking about that.
No, yeah. It's not the good. You need the ones you can inject, like the rubs and all that shit.
I don't want an androgel. I don't want a pill. I want to go straight to the heart.
Hmm. I'll go to Walgreens and get a needle and inject a rub. I don't give a fuck. Let's stick with death threats for now.
Okay.
All right.
This guy in a 20-year-old in Akron, Ohio. He was really feeling the Ottawa truckers protest. And like, he's like, here I am stuck in Ohio. What can I do to help out? So he Googled Ottawa police station or something.
Oh, no.
And he got a phone number. He called in. He made a bomb threat. And his intention was like, I'm going to distract the police in Ottawa so they'll leave the fucking truckers alone, dude. And then so he calls in, makes a bomb threat, hangs up. He's feeling real good about it. He calls back. And I think the second time he said, I've been shot. And that was when he discovered that, like, because he's in Akron, Ohio, when he Google searched for Ottawa Police Department, it gave him the police department in Ottawa, Ohio, where he was making death threats and there was no trucker convoy at all.
Oh, no, this is going to go really bad.
Yeah. He just Googled and then did the first fucking number and got it wrong and started making bomb threats.
Yeah, like somebody yesterday on Wheel of Fortune was from like Beverly Hills, Wisconsin. And I'm like, all right.
Oh, yeah. Well, there's a Hollywood, Florida.
Yeah,
it ain't Hollywood.
No, no.
So
this might actually work out for this asshole because like he's making no state lines crossed, much less an international border. You got to imagine like making a bomb threat across the Canadian border. That's a fucking fine.
Let's talk bomb threats for a second. Do you guys believe, because I believe this.
You're talking about the Rage Against the Machine song, right?
If you gave me...
Or wait, that's bomb track.
If you gave me 5 bomb threats, because every once in a while, there's a real one, right? Like, there's been real bomb threats. Like, the Olympic bomber...
Wait, where there's a real bomb?
Well, like, I'm just saying...
A real bomb threat or a real bomb?
Like, a real bomb and bomb threat. Like,
I think that's extremely rare to have a real
bomb.
It
is, but it's happened. And that's why these continue to happen, right?
My least favorite was the bomb around the pizza delivery guy's neck, where they had the video of it. Oh, my God.
That's a weird documentary.
Don't go down that
too.
Rabbit hole. You'll scare yourself to death.
So, anyway, if you gave me 5 bomb threats, and one of them was the real one, like it actually...
Oh, you have to figure out which one's real?
I think
this
I could tell...
This is an awesome game show.
I think I could tell the
like
fake
Die
ones.
Die Hard 3 or something, right? Where he was running around. He had one was in a fountain. And
yes!
Like,
because I feel like it's the old gun under your shirt and stuff. It's like, you don't have nothing. You know what I'm saying?
That looks like a finger. I can see your fingernails.
If I was the 911 dispatcher and then someone called in a bomb threat, I think I could tell that it was fake.
I know I could. With my power of profiling people on voice only.
I'm like, you don't have nothing.
I can listen to anybody and tell you exactly what their character is about. I've always had that superpower.
Now, I've never heard a real bomb threat or a fake one. But
I'm going to guess that the real bomb threats, just based on not hearing many of them, is going to sound awfully boring.
Because
it's real.
Yeah, I think the fake bomb threats, I feel like they're going to try too hard.
They're
trying too hard. It's like we can tell when a caller's real or fake or when they're telling a story.
Based on their nerves. I can tell by the level of anxiety you have in your voice. Maybe that's why I'm good at it. I can hear your anxiety, and I'm like, yeah, you're too stressed out. This is fake because you're working too hard.
Yeah.
If you got this all planned out, if you really just got done defusing a bomb, then making the phone call or getting the bomb ready, right? You're putting the bomb together. That's some sketchy shit because you could blow your head off, right? Making the phone call is not as stressful.
calm.
Yeah, so you're calm. You're going to be
more
calm.
But the fake bomb threat, your anxiety, your...
Because it's never been real. The hardest thing you're having to do is make the call.
What say you, Ross?
Well, think about, who in America has actually... done some bombings. Remember, who's the guy with the hood? Kaczynski in the woods with the fucking...
Unabomber.
The Unabomber, right? So, that's the guy who put together... He made up his mind that, bombs is the way to get shit done, and he had the technical skills to do it without, blowing himself up, and he could get the bomb to his targets and make it go off when he wanted to. He didn't threaten. He just sent the fucking bombs and bombed these people.
Hold on a second. You just added a whole...
That is true.
...another brilliant layer to my new business, finding real bomb threats. Yeah.
But other bomb threats actually happened, and the person who called in was the bomber. I think the Olympic bomber, they received a call saying there was going to be a bomb.
But it was never Richard Jewell.
No, but it was...
That guy got fucking railroaded.
Yeah, he did get railroaded. But it ruined his life.
It was the person that actually put the bomb, because no one else would have known it, but it was a real bomb threat and a bomb went off. So,
Interesting.
There has been bomb threats that have been real.
That guy, though, his real thing was abortion clinics. He had bombed some abortion clinics, and then that was his real thing. No warning. He just blew up the fucking abortion clinics. This one, he was he was living in the woods fucking hiding from the FBI. And he's like, I'm not getting enough attention for my abortion clinic crusade. So he did this one for attention.
Let me ask you a question. If you're blowing up abortion clinics, aren't you killing the mothers and the unborn babies at the same time? It's kind of counterproductive to saving the babies.
I think he was after the doctors, Dan. In his mind, the doctors were Satan on Earth, just murdering babies. So he timed it. So mainly you got the doctors.
You're trying to add logic to an insane act.
There's still that old lady that sits in front of that abortion clinic down the road here. And it hasn't been an abortion clinic for 9 years. And she's still out there with her pamphlet.
Yeah.
I don't have the heart to tell her.
These are all nuts. Anyway, you got a last story, Ross?
Speaking of nuts, it's the last one. I got so many fucking stories. Okay, all right. This guy, do you know what a sovereign citizen is, Tom?
I know it's what I yell at police officers when I get pulled over. I don't know what it means, though.
Yeah. I've heard the term, and all I know is that if you're yelling it, most likely you have an AR to flak check it, and you're walking down the neighborhood.
So I don't fully understand it myself, but I think it's tied to the... Federal Reserve. I think it's tied to the Federal Reserve and this idea. The Trumpies were pushing it around a lot when he didn't win the election, and they were having to come up with some real nonsense. There's certain people that think when we went with off the gold standard, went with the Federal Reserve, like banknotes instead of gold coins and shit, that the United States stopped being a country and became a corporation. And so these people opt out of the corporation of the United States.
I'm a sovereign citizen.
And they're sovereign citizens of the actual country of the United States, but they don't want anything to do with the fucking corporation that runs the place where they live, right?
Yes.
So, most frequently, Dan, you'll see them getting pulled over by the cops with their bullshit license plates. This guy in Michigan, though, he is facing, three felonies, all punishable by 2 years in prison or a $500 fine. So we'll see if he gets lucky or not.
Well, that's extreme. No. 2 years or $500. Oh, Jesus Christ. Look at that. I'm hoping towards a $500.
I like that. I think that's awesome.
2 goddamn years?
That didn't even sit in my mind until you put it out. I'm like, yeah, that's pretty bad. That's a bad trade.
Like, even if you gave me $1,000 fine, I'll be happy. Anyway, go ahead.
It probably is up to 2 years, but yeah, it says here 2 years in prison or $500 fines. What he did, he said, hey, I'm a sovereign citizen. I shouldn't be responsible for taxes. I don't know how this translates to what he did, which was he wrote $1 million checks to the state to pay his taxes and sent them in. And so the state went to cash these checks, and there was no account that existed with these checks. He was just stating, just take them.
Well, this here's sounds, a piece
like,
of paper.
That's
this
the state's
like
fault.
Shit we would do.
Hold on. That's the state's fault for like, you get the check and it's like, written as cat scratch.
Don't even cash it.
It's from
nobody
Wachovia.
Sends a million. Don't even cash it.
You can't even have a million in a regular fucking Wachovia pink account or whatever. So the fact that they even went to try to cash it, that's on you. You're an idiot. You should have just been like, fuck this guy and then go get him. Don't even try. You should know better. Anyway, every once in a while, this happens. Like, what's the blade? What the
Wesley Snipes?
Wesley Snipes.
Wow, I did it again.
So the like
we have a special link up.
The
I would have said a K-bar.
The argument is like, all right, this is not based on what the United States was supposed to be. This is different, and this is not the George Washington's vision. And
yeah,
so this
isn't what our founding fathers
wanted. George Washington's vision.
Yeah, it's always some shit like sovereign citizens. Like this, I'm not paying because this is my right. And it's like.
Taxation is theft.
They're gonna get you.
Yeah. Who? They're gonna get you. Yeah.
They're not. No one's gonna accept your excuse.
They're
gonna get you.
But before we get
don't
them,
even try.
I say we get them because I'm paying my taxes, you know, and all that kind of stuff. I do think they should say, look, hey, I ain't doing this, sovereign citizen. I ain't paying. This ain't George Washington's vision. And the person should give them a solid. We didn't think about that. I'm sorry.
Let's reassess.
And then they should exit the premises and leave them alone for one full day and then do it again for real the next day. Okay. Let them have a victory for one day just so the next day it's really shitty.
You're like, oh, sovereign? Uh-oh.
Hold on.
Jen, we gotta leave.
We got a sovereign. I am so sorry. My God. I am embarrassed.
Just so they say
So embarrassed. My God. You know what? Take these. Here's some muffins. Take all of this. You know, we apologize.
I also hate the new video that are circulating like Facebook or whatever, where it's like some guy that brought in a Lamborghini from the Middle East or whatever.
Oh, I saw that.
And then
we're on the same algorithm.
Yeah, and then, finally.
And then the thing's like, this cop doesn't know the law. Look at the guy. He knows
that
the
guy
law.
Was a dickhead, though. Come on.
And the cop.
And he didn't know the law.
Of course, because he's a fucking cop in Wisconsin or some shit. All he does is go pull. Like, so he doesn't know the international rules about taking
stop, start, go fast, don't go fast. He knows the traffic.
So he's like, under this statute or whatever, I'm allowed to have this piece of paper that gives me the right to drive my car on the right side of the road or whatever the fuck.
You know, it would be really hard for me not to crumple that paper and start peeing in the window of that car.
And the cop doesn't know the goddamn. He's not.
Which is what the guy was trying to tell him. He's like, look, I know this is odd. That's why I'm trying to tell you what it is.
Yeah, but the
guy was like, no, you're wrong. You're wrong. The cop was like, come on, it's the cockiness. The guy did not know the fucking law.
I'm with you.
Also, the cockiness of the guy, of course the cop didn't know the law, and you know he doesn't know the law, so you're being a dick.
You're baiting the cop into, you knew that he was going to pull you over,
disagree.
And you knew you were going to whip out your piece of paper, right?
He gave him every document that he asked for, and he still was fighting him.
Well, because the cop, he's like, this is an odd, I don't blame people for shit that is way, like, that never happens.
That seems like somebody's trying to pull a fast one on you? Yeah.
Because the cop doesn't want to be made a fool, right? So he's going to be skeptical about whether or not this is real, and he doesn't know. So, like, yeah, of course he's confused about because no cop knows every goddamn international law about the vehicles and the driver's license and shit. Like, shit that never happens. It's an anomaly. Like, this is the only time in this guy's career this is ever going to happen.
Right, that's why that guy told him that.
Easy. You've been watching a lot of Yellowstone.
But again, the guy knows that.
No, I'm with you.
And
it's like he's doing it just so he can get a cop to do that, and then get the cop to get mad. And I'm like, well, now you're just doing now you're just doing it for social media. Why don't you just...
Listen, the cop's a dick. Cops are dicks. We know that. No shit. Cops are dicks. This guy's a dick. You're all fucking dicks.
Wow.
Anyway.
Jesus.
All right.
Okay.
All right, that's it,
the person who Tom said was hardwired to be a dick.
God damn it. That was a long time.
What?
Anyway. Oh, God, that's fun.
All right, Ross. Who's...
Let's talk about the podcast, man. Yeah. Anybody new?
Let me, because I got so many stories for you guys. Let's run through the headlines we didn't get to. 60,000 bees stolen. Holy shit. There's only three guys left who have been to every Super Bowl, and they're all basically saying, eh, not after this year.
I love those guys. But yeah, they've been dropping like flies.
Somebody broke into the Pentagon. A chicken. Miami cracking down on peacocks, Tom. I was trying to give you some local shit. God, and my personal favorite story, definitely look this one up. They're going to have to take down a historic bridge to float out this super yacht that Jeff Bezos bought.
Hilarious. Yeah, he bought that crazy laser yacht. Now they're actually changing historic cities based on how big his boat is.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's sad.
I feel bad for billionaires nowadays.
Yeah, you do.
Because they can't do whatever they want like they used to be able to. Now everything's on goddamn social media. So, like...
Elon Musk jet, like, you're telling me where
I mean, they still do what they want.
Like, I don't think you heard me. They're taking down a historic bridge to float.
They're tearing down the bridge for him. For his yacht.
Yeah, well, but there was a time when he used to just ride right through it. You
I'm
know?
Sure.
Like a super villain, like Groove.
And no one would know, except the people that live there.
The city threw a fucking fit. Like, people rioted and shit, and then they were like, he paid us a lot of money.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. That's what happens. He paid for it. He's like, how much to get this fucking bridge out of my goddamn way? And he paid it, so who cares?
That's the only part of the story, Ross, that I actually liked, is that the riot, I'm like, oh my God, I feel so sorry for these people. They just want to keep this intact and keep the integrity. And then the city's like, nah, dog, look at this money. Look at how much money we got. Look at this. This is way better than a bridge.
They're like, do you know how many people worked on that fucking boat? It's the only way to get it to the ocean. We're taking the goddamn bridge.
Listen, he could turn into a supervillain, and he just wants to ride his yacht and bang.
We need some experiments. We need some really bad shit to be going down. Like, I don't see it yet.
So,
right now, building a submarine in the basement of the Library of Congress, and he's just gonna be like, "Yeah, tear down the Library of Congress, float my submarine out of here."
Here's some money.
I'm just saying, back in the day, if you were a billionaire, you could get away with a lot of shit. They're like, hey, people live here. Like, bury them all. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And nobody would know. And then nobody. Like, you own the newspapers.
Bring me my maids. Bring me my maids and a hammer.
The Washington Post.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, but he doesn't own TikTok and shit, and we saw it, I see it, and they're like, oh, Jeff Bezos, that dickhead, he's taking this bridge down. They're like, oh, get him. But I kind of feel bad for him. Because
why? Nothing happened to him.
You know, 50 years ago, nobody would have known nothing. That's all I'm saying.
Free the billionaires is what I say.
They're free. They're freer than anybody.
You gotta free them.
They're going to space.
It used to be free. Now it's too much red tape for these billionaires.
Leave them alone.
Ross, anybody on the podcast?
Just go check out Old Tots with Ross in your fucking podcast app. Come see me at the Bull and Bush Wednesday night open mic. Come watch me yell at somebody for doing something wrong. That's been my thing lately. Every other Saturday, first and third Saturdays, we got a showcase for you. Definitely go to Waze and select Australian Ross as your voice. I need a bunch more of you guys to do that before the money kicks in, please. And come see me this Saturday at the Orlando Improv. I'm part of the Comedians in Drag doing comedy show, not improv main stage, but if you've ever been to the Improv, that little meet and greet area where they have a shitty little secondary stage, that's where we'll be tomorrow night at 7.
Dude, that's a nice stage, and that's a nice area, like, to do comedy.
I hear a tumbleweed there. That's a good little stage. It's fine for what it is. You know, it's just not the main stage of the Improv.
Are you
going to
roll out there,
Sam?
Yeah,
I think Sam and I are going to roll out there and see you. Like,
fuck yeah, guys. Doors at 6, show at 7. Come on through.
Cool. But yeah, Tom's right. It's a good stage.
And Ross doesn't even have to buy a wig for this because he grew his hair out just for this show.
He's got like legit, luxurious, cool hair. So,
Sam, bring some makeup. I don't have any makeup.
I don't have any makeup.
I probably have more makeup than Sam, and that's because I'm weird.
All right. Bring some makeup. I don't have any makeup.
All right, buddy. We'll talk to you soon.
See you, Ross.
Bye, guys.
All right, man. Later. Have a great rest of your day.
All right, let's take
a
quick break.
He must have got some good weed, because, man, his stories were tight. He was popping. I need to get good weed. I haven't tried this thing yet, because I vowed not to try anything until we get to the end of the show.
Let's try it in the break. We're coming in for a landing.
I know, but I like to be able to see my buttons and know what's happening. You guys like the Linda Lindas. I know Sam likes the Linda Lindas. Brand new single from them called Growing Up. On the tail end of that, we'll come out of that into Cat Bells. They have a new single called Same As You. This one's fun because it starts cold, so I'm just going to go into it. So you ready?
Yep.
One, two.
Growing up isn't something you can make happen when you want it to. But since we're all growing up together, I will remember you every day. I'll feel the same way too.
We're falling apart. That's what you're hearing, is you're hearing us fall apart. Like, it used to be when we do the show, during the breaks, we'd sit here and say, oh, what are you doing this week? Oh, I'm going to fucking Warp Tour, man. Do action sports tour. What are you doing? My balls hurt. I got the high cholesterol. I'm doing this. My wife won't fuck me. Sam's talking about, you know, well, I'm not gonna spread your, that's your business.
Whoa, don't spread.
No. I just, like, when you tell me things, I need to be better about being, like, I am very bad at everything on the show is on the show. You tell me stuff in confidence, that's your business. I'm not going to say that. I'm not going to just wing that out there. He's talking about toothpicks, whistling toothpicks, and
yeah.
That's his business.
Mm-hmm. Only a few things get better with time. Wine, some sort of charges. Okay.
Couldn't that just be an opinion?
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, because people say that beer, I remember when I first got into craft beer, people would say things like, oh, you got to let that age. And I guess there is
some of them you can do that, but
for the most part, you just want fresh beer, right? You want it, like, as soon as that stuff is like, oh, it's ready, drink it.
Yeah, you put it in the barrel, it absorbs the thing, you do the thing. Let's do some dumb
perfectly said.
Perfectly
said.
You know.
I like that. Oh my God. I put my wife's boob in my mouth last night.
The whole thing?
Yeah, like a baby. And it made her laugh and laugh. Too many topics on the list today. It's the end of the motherfucking show. So come on, baby. Let's dump them out and play. I want to see your topics. I want to also see your bottom X.
When are we getting booty shorts to say bottom X?
Did you just think of that?
No. You brought it up before. Like how it used to say juicy on people's booty cheeks.
No.
I still wear all my juicy couture.
Check out our hookups page. There's a ton of different discounts on there for Tom and Dan listeners. So if you go to tomanddan.com and then just select hookups on the top, it brings you to a page, a bunch of sponsors that offer discounts to you guys. Mm-hmm. And we don't talk about them that much because they're just hookup sponsors, but some of our main sponsors have hookups. It's just if you're looking for anything, check that page. As our main sponsor page too.
There's a lot of stuff on here, man.
Yeah, yeah. I know Precision Door just came back on, and okay. So if you
awesome.
Andrea's looking for a garage door.
Just in time for Andrea's father to be in need of some assistance.
Yep.
There's all kinds of crazy stuff on here. Organic meat, Sticker Wolf.
Yeah, Burn.
Yep. We got Andrew Allen Music. There's a buddy that wrote all of our BDM theme songs. Like, if you need a custom song, well, we happen to have an educator. The guy teaches at a college, and he is a classically trained composer and pianist. That's a weird one, but it's an awesome one, right? Who else is going to be able to offer that?
Yep.
So check it out.
All right. What do we got first here?
Tom, apparently you've been singing Sublime lyrics wrong your whole life.
Okay.
Oh, hold on a second.
This is upsetting. Thought it was your favorite band.
Well, who is your favorite band? It's No Effects, right?
I don't have a favorite. It's like a best friend.
I knew you were going to say this. Like, best friend.
No favorite of anything.
I don't have anything. You like hamburger? What's your favorite food? I don't have a favorite food. It's just something to me. It's just something for fuel.
No, it's not that. I like things, but I
don't. You got a favorite article of clothing you like to wear?
No.
You have a favorite color. How about a body part on your wife that you find the most pleasing? You sucked all the air out of the room, man. That hurt me. I was like, well, I was coming closer to you.
Anyway.
Oh, you brushed past that. So you didn't answer.
I
have a favorite. That was between me and my wife.
Oh,
sir.
Step back. It's like what I just said.
So
step stand
back.
Down.
Step back and stand down. Yeah.
But stand by.
But be ready.
Just in case.
But, anyway.
Boogie woogie flu.
Sublime Santeria came on.
Oh, you fucked up Santeria?
Do you call it Sublime Santeria now? That one sounds like a woman's name.
And there's been a long-going show joke about my love for Santeria. And we've sung it many a times on a cruise, right? Yeah. During karaoke.
That or Bon Bon Jovi.
Someone will put Santeria, and then I'll get up there and sing Santeria with everybody. So,
and you do this dance.
Cashed Out did it at our land cruise this time last year.
I don't remember any of that.
Yeah. They played Santeria.
There's so little that I remember from our tales.
So I'm going to go with Samantha on this because she should know the right lyrics.
Oh,
and
God.
I'm going to ask
well,
you.
She can look them up.
No, well, don't look them up.
Okay.
Oh, well, I won't look them up either because I did in preparation for this. I mean, I'm pretty good with lyrics.
Like, my husband used to play in a reggae band. I'm pretty sure I know the lyrics.
Okay, so yes.
Let's see, though, maybe.
So, for my entire life, or at least since...
I think every person knows Santeria, right?
Yes, and everybody knows it, and I thought I knew it as well. And now, there's only...
Is it about the number of the brothers?
Nope, no.
And how horny they were?
No.
And then left her on the street?
No. Oh, that's date rape, right?
No.
Oh, yeah, Santeria. Anyway...
Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
So... The portion of the song where it says, I'll pop a cap in Sancho's ass and slap her.
You might got me.
I'll pop a cap in Sancho's ass and slap her down.
Down.
Is it not down?
Slap her down. Like, I'm gonna only beat her. I'm going to kill him.
Right.
But I'm only going to slap her around because, you know, that's what you do.
You weren't saying.
I thought it was slap. Her dad around.
Slap her dad around. You added extra syllables?
Because it's funny. It's because in his fantasy, he's like, oh, fuck you, Sancho. And you know what? I'm going to slap your fucking dad around for good measure. Hey, get over here, old man. Get over here, old man. I'm slap your fucking tits around.
My entire
slap
time.
Slap her dad around.
This is going in the awards.
I'm
going
to be singing this. I'm going to be doing a new version of
this. I can't be the only one. There has
to be. I think
you
are.
There has to
be
other people.
Can you pull the song just to play that one part? Because I can't even hear I can't even hear two words there.
I sang it out loud.
We might get flagged like we did last week on YouTube.
Where did you sing it in front of people?
No, at the land cruise. I sang it in all of cruises, every goddamn karaoke. I slap her dad around. I thought it was slap her dad around. Like your dad started talking shit or something. Now
but
that I think about it,
that's a lot of assumptions. That's a lot of assumptions about how
it sounds
far away.
Like slap her dad around. It doesn't like slap her down.
So in your fantasy,
dad around.
So in your fantasy,
I thought it was slap her dad around.
Round, slap dad around.
So in your fantasy, Sancho has fucked over. He was fucking your girl, Sancho, and you're like, so this, let me tell you how this is fucking going down. I just killed your fucking boyfriend. And I slapped her dad around. That's what I'm fucking doing.
Well, I thought the dad came by talking shit too, and
hey, you kill fucking Sancho. He's a good boy. Hey, why are you killing Sancho? And I don't like you around my daughter. And you're like, oh, get over here, you fucking, I'll kill you like Sancho. You know what? No, I'm not going to kill you. I'm just going to slap you around. Slap your dad around.
Oh. See, I thought you were tricking me because I was like, oh, is it not down? Have I been saying it wrong my whole life?
So I screamed out loud, slap your dad around when my son's going like, this is my favorite song. And I was showing
Tommy. Oh, my God, it's in the blood.
And then she's like, what'd you say? It's slap her down. And then I'm like, down? Okay, watch this.
How far
around.
Do I got to go?
It's in the first four bars.
Other people had to have thought this. I can't be the only one.
Sancho,
here we go.
Well, I'd pop a cap in Sancho and I'd
slap her down. No, dude, it's down.
He goes slap
her around.
No, he goes slap her down. He just does like,
Yeah.
Sounded like that around to me, but I've been saying that around
Bradley,
forever.
Bradley, believe it or not, Bradley,
20 years.
He was pretty soulful, you know? Like, he would do a lot of runs and stuff like that.
I sang it at the goddamn cruise, everything. No one's ever.
Why do you constantly put extra words and syllables in things, Mr. Disney?
Yeah, like, you do, yeah.
Like, why?
Because I don't know how to talk, dude.
Okay. Yeah, you've been telling me that.
Me, and I'm an idiot.
You keep telling me you don't know how to talk.
But here's how I know other people had to have thought the same thing, because I am an idiot, and I think like other idiots. Because I know.
Okay, Chigardi in our Twitch chat room.
Oh, he thought it, right?
Hold on. Twitch.tv/TomDanLive if you want to be like these guys that are watching us live. He says, I may have sung Slap Her Derriere.
Dare? No, that doesn't sound like Derriere.
He says, I may have said Slap Her Derriere.
I think I can hear Derriere more than dad around.
It makes more sense. Why would you just jump to beating up her dad?
Yeah, I mean, her dad up. Was
well,
not involved.
My dad showed up. Like, and in my...
You've already committed murder at this point. So now you're like, I'm such a fucking psycho that I'm going to start slapping your dad. Where is he at? Is it a nurse?
I think I know why. I think Tom's brain heard it later in the song when he refers to himself as daddy.
No, he has this grit dad, some sort of weird grit dad obsession where he thinks at some point that he's going to have to fight some other kid that's gonna beat you up. There's some fucking weird weird thing you got.
Bradley's white trash. He's hanging out with white trash. He's on Long
Beach. When Ric Flair's. okay, hold on.
And then there's like white trash. And then like in trailer parks
Look
and shit.
Up
the dad's
Ric
always
Flair
there.
And then son-in-law.
So
because I think Ric Flair at one point got in a fight with his son-in-law, beat him up, and Ric Flair had to go to the back of his double wide trailer and lay down on the bed and stop his nose from getting.
So you're talking shit. You're arguing.
Ric Flair gets suplexed into a pool by his future son-in-law.
That's dope. That's the way to live your life.
You're out there talking shit in front of the trailer park, and the dad comes out and you slap him around too. That's in my mind.
Dead right.
My God.
I might start doing it. What if I start doing it?
Other people slap had to have thought of it.
Dead know.
It sounds like.
I slapped her dead around. I kind of like it.
It's weird that it's slap her down.
Well,
like,
he's being soulful. He's like, slap her down.
Okay, here's
he's singing like a singer does.
Here's one that Norm did that was wrong lyrics. You know, everyone is familiar with Smash Mouth, right? Somebody once told me,
the world is going to roll me.
He thought it was, the world is macaroni.
Well, he's a big fat sucker.
Of course he thought that was a dream. Take that, Norm. You've done nothing but good for us.
That's true.
You know, we like to single out our nicest listeners and then call them big fat suckers. It's just, it's the way. It is the way.
All right.
Should we get out of here?
Yeah.
We have other stuff.
Let's do a few more. I'm feeling it. Let's do a few more.
Trying to find the percentage off for Gabriella Plants that happened earlier in the week when you guys were doing commercials.
Oh, my God. Did you write that down?
Tom told me to.
Oh, my God.
Well, these are all about how stupid we are. Because we're doing a Gabriella Plants.
We should change the name of this segment.
Dumb old men.
No, it would be funnier if we instead of dumb about and we just call it how stupid we are.
So me and Daniel were refreshing our ACT commercial. And we get the Gabriella Plants. And then I'm like the promo code, Tom and Dan, gets you, I think it's 20% off.
What are you doing?
I know.
You're getting it wrong.
We didn't know. And that's the thing. And then we started looking at the filing cabinet. We're like, oh, God, this is a fucking nightmare.
Call Butler.
You started doing math. You were like buying a plant and doing
so
math.
This is how we figured it out. So then Daniel's like, I got it. So Daniel went.
I got the longest way to solve it.
And then bought the plant and then put the promo code in. And he's like, all right, I got $6 off. And he's
I got nothing.
And then we spent the next 5 minutes straight trying to
figure out. I heard you guys struggling in here.
What's the percentage? It was a $32. It was pretty. Why? He's like, why'd you bottle the $32? Why'd you go exotic? I don't know, plant.
And then I'm like, is it the percentage off the tax too? I don't think it is.
Wait, what are you thinking?
And then Samantha's like, give me 15%.
A window to the mind. Give me, what are you thinking? You hear your two bosses in here struggling like two rats caught in traps just flopping around.
At one point, I did not know you were fake buying a plant to try and do
But when you heard that I was, how disappointed in me were you?
I was like, oh, fuck.
You were disappointed in me.
Let me just go to the website.
She knows.
You look at
me
sometimes.
It's literally on our website's front page.
I want to know how you feel about me. When you look at me versus him, you think, this guy, he can save me, right? Like, when I let you down that bad, you have to, it has to shake your confidence.
It does.
Okay.
Yeah. But it's like
because you expect it from him, but when I do it, you're like, oh shit, and I do it worse. That was so.
And I'm like, they're both doing
what
it.
I did was so much more stupid than anything Tom's ever done. I'm like, well, I'll just waste the company's money to figure out how much money our listeners get off. That's why I can't have my own fucking credit card. Do you get it now?
Yeah.
That's why.
And it still didn't help because we couldn't figure out the math.
Well, I don't know math. I know how to buy stuff, but I don't know how to do
it. It's 15% off. It's right there on TomandDan.com.
All right, thank you. Thank you, Sam. Appreciate it. All right.
What else we got?
Milk on cereal.
We can end with this because I'd like to know if people agree with me. When I remember when I talked about going to my friend Jeremy Shanley's house and his dad was a chef and he gave me cheddar cheese for the first time.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
And it was
sorry.
I know it's trash, but hey, you know, we're Florida people here. And I use that as a life marker of like a time when I realized I really enjoy cooking and like good food and like quality ingredients and stuff like that. Again, at Jeremy Shanley's house, I remember I was eating cereal. And I was in there, you know, like you wake up early Saturday mornings. We're going out to watch like Voltron or something. Like he loved anime and stuff like that. One of my only friends that was into that kind of stuff. And one of my only friends' parents who had that kind of stuff. So we were going to get our cereal and we make our bowl of cereal. And I remember I was going to make my milk. And the way the dentist has made cereal is you fill up the amount of cereal you want. And then you pour the milk in the bowl. And then to the point where you are now floating the cereal.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Mrs. Shanley was so mad. Like, what are you doing? Like, it was like, what are you wasting all the milk? Like, because in their house, and I think they're right. So I'm gonna go on their side of this particular question I have. I believe that was the day that I learned, and from that point on, I use milk as an accompaniment to my cereal. It is not a splash, more than a splash, but I'm certainly not floating my cereal. Up until that point, I used to be a floater. Now I'm a splasher. I splash the milk in there, kind of mix it up. It's meant to wet the cereal. It's not meant to be an entire, because there's nothing that Mrs. Shanley, and she explained it to me, there's nothing that made her more angry than when you finish the cereal and then you have a cup and a half of milk in a bowl.
That's
when you scrape the sugar.
But some people don't do that. They'll just dump out the milk. Some people don't drink that.
You get your ass beat in my house.
So I'm just saying, what is the proper way to dress your cereal? Because I think she's right. I think you put in like maybe an inch.
I put equal parts.
Maybe a half an inch, an inch of milk in there.
No, fuck no. It's way too dry.
I'm
with you. I always thought you floated it up.
No.
To the brim.
And that's too much. Like it's equal parts.
No, it's not equal parts. That's a waste of milk.
No, I drink the milk.
But, like, that's a huge meal,
though. Why do you think I'm so tall?
Good point.
Like
I never did it from that point on. It stunted my growth.
See?
The weight of the liquid milk should be 5 times the weight of the cereal.
God damn.
Because it's heavier. Like,
okay.
Did you drink all your milk after you ate your cereal?
Yeah, because there's sugar in the bottom. Right. When I was a kid.
Sugar water, yeah.
God. Okay, maybe she's wrong because the chat room, I haven't
had
one.
A lot of floaters in
no,
here.
No, I haven't had one person say that they're a splasher. And now I'm a splasher. I changed my whole life.
But then you don't get any milk because it absorbs and then there's not even a milk in the bottom.
No, there's a little bit in there, but it's like, you know, I'm kind of the same way with ice cream and toppings. It's like, you know, like if I'm going to do toppings, I don't do a shit ton of ice cream. I want to be a ton of toppings.
See, I'm not a cereal guy now, but when I was a kid, I would eat soggy cereal. I liked it soggy. Like Fruit Loops.
I bet you do.
I would just let the Fruit Loops just sit there in the milk until they became basically
like oatmeal.
Yeah, like super mushy.
Like, what is that? Overnight oat.
Sugar. Yeah. Sugar mush. And then eat that. It was a white trash. Like, that's what I thought you were supposed to
what
do.
What do your boys eat for breakfast every morning?
Oh, I cook them eggs.
Microwaved pancakes.
You want to know what Maisie eats? I'll give you the full rundown. This morning was gratuitous. 8 mini powdered donuts. 2 bowls of sugar cereal.
I couldn't even eat 8 donuts.
2 bowls of sugar cereal. Like Lucky Charms, some sort of trash cereal.
How does Andrea allow this?
And 5 slices of full fat bacon. She's like Trucker Basie. But it's the only meal she'll eat. That's it. That she fuels up and that runs her all day.
I gotta do fried eggs, pancakes, or waffles, and then also fresh fruit.
God, yours is like being in a goddamn Hyatt
Continental breakfast. Yeah, it's a continental breakfast.
Like if I ate that, I'd be go to a business meeting.
I'm cooking eggs every morning, and then sometimes it's bagels and eggs. Anyway,
bagels. What child eats a bagel?
Tommy likes a sensible bagel.
I like a bagel.
Fucking nerd.
I like a bagel with just a little bit of capers.
Max, I won't eat that shit. Max will eat toast. I have to make bagel and then make toast for Max.
Jesus.
And then jelly and butter, eggs. Anyway,
oh, fuck.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah, anything to plug? What's going on with semantics this week?
We'll be on Twitch tonight. You can watch us play some games. We'll also be on Twitch at the Super Bowl. We're going to be at the Super Bowl. No, we're Twitching the Super Bowl, so please tune in for that. We're going to be giving away some free t-shirts. What else? We got a new You Heard About This One coming out on Sunday about the Myers-Briggs test. Derek did his episode on the Myers-Briggs test, and how it's all bullshit. And then we will be recording next Friday with our friends the Phoenixes. And we have our five-year anniversary coming up Friday, February 20th, Sunday, February 20th at noon at Rock Pit Brewing.
And you got your beer coming out that day.
Yeah, we're going to have our own Semantic Sunday beer, which is a Vienna lager. We're going to have really cool can art that Eric Pabon did for us.
It's great.
It's really cool.
And we're going to have shirts and beers for beers and beer glasses for sale out there.
Yep.
So,
make
come
sure
on
you
out.
Head on out and check it out.
The Semantic shirt is awesome. Daniel's right. Shirt. It makes my arms look good.
Yeah.
It does. It fits really well.
Yeah. When I put that one on, like even Andrea and I matched it with we both
trying. It's a good shirt.
I think everybody here is trying to be a little bit healthier. And I match it out with some red shoes because it's got some nice red accents in it. And can you snag those online?
Is that possible? Semanticspodcast.com/store.
There you go. Check all of that out. As always, go to TomandDan.com. A video of this will be on YouTube. If you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, I'd really appreciate it. It's gotten bigger and bigger, and it's going pretty well. Just search Tom and Dan Live.
Also, sign up to become a BDM if you're not a BDM already. And if you are a BDM, make sure your address is correct on our site. You have to sign up or go on the desktop and then look at your account and make sure that it's still your current address because in April, we're doing a BDM Appreciation Week, and we're sending over $5,000 worth of prizes.
Yeah.
I mean, some people are going to get a lot of thank you cards and stickers, because $5,000 doesn't go very far.
Not anymore.
We're going to buy an Oculus, some big screen TVs, and randomly
gaming systems, some just some cool shit.
Yeah, and but we're going to try to give as much back to BDMs as a thank you. It's all sponsored by Streamline Mortgage. Big thank you to Streamline for, helping us out with doing this program.
Brian believes in you guys because you use him, and he loves working with you. So continue to do that, and we'll get to give you guys... Man, if everybody used Streamline, we would have so many prizes to give you. It would be insane.
Yeah.
So just keep it up.
Get that new Tom and Dan hoodie tonight on sale.
I love that thing.
Yeah. We'll let all the BDMs know exactly when. The text will go out and everything. But yeah, we'll be on there tonight. And we didn't order enough, so you better get
one. Nice job.
God damn.
We're terrible at this. Guys, thank you so much for listening. We love you. Thanks so much. And
bye-bye.
I can't publish that. It's mediocre.